It's Dub Life. Every Sunday afternoon, it's Dub Life. Natalie and Kaya too. If you ride the horse, say, make sure you squeeze it tight. It's Dub Life tonight.
Safety.
Hello, friends. It's episode 189 of Dub Life. And it is Friday. It is the Friday of Ranger Stop and Pop Atlanta, which we're going to head down to a little bit early tonight. Similar to what Kai and I did with MomoCon a couple weeks ago, we're going to try to go down for kind of the preview night tonight. It's all the way downtown. And see if we can maybe get the thing signed that we want to get signed. Then we're going to go back tomorrow. Victoria's going to join us. James is going to join us. And we'll take a lot more leisurely time around. And all that stuff. But before we get to all that, don't forget to use the hashtag BDubFit. As you're watching this, we just concluded the week of dub. You just should have had 7 straight days of dub. I hope you enjoyed the week of dub. Still have today's episode. Tomorrow's Monday Motivation, so you'll technically get 9 straight days of dub. Plus, we had a live stream recently. So there's been a lot of dub. Here comes Rufus storming down. So don't forget to use hashtag BDubFit. You want to win that signed Judith Hogue beat-up fit. Go back to Tuesday's video and check it out. Make sure you follow the directions to enter to win that prize. Use regular hashtag beat-up fit for prizes at the end of the month. Also, if you haven't watched yesterday's Big Bad Toy Store pile of loot haul video, click on the Big Bad Toy Store pile of loot. Again, they gave very positive things to say about the first month of usage. So thank you for everybody that's clicking on it. Whether you're buying stuff, pre-ordering, or just browsing, it all helps. I appreciate that. And we're almost 5,000 subscribers. Got a lot of stuff to give away. Isn't that right, Kaya? Yeah. A lot of stuff to give away. But before we get to Ranger Stop, let's take a gander over here at this stuff. So first, this is stuff we're actually selling on eBay. I will try to remember to put a link to my eBay store or eBay account in the description below. If you're interested, some of our extra stuff, these are extra, like I said, I don't always know what Pokemon we have. Those are all extras. So if Kai already has the big figure, the big card out of it, we're going to sell them extra random stuff that we've picked up. I picked up 2 of these accidentally, whatever. So this stuff will be listed on my eBay if you want to buy. Go look at that. Now, some things I have picked up recently. I opened this guy up on a live stream. This is the new ones I've got here. Combatants Fight for Glory from Zezre Studios. This guy's name was Victor. He's super cool. Super cool. The helmet comes off. They kind of are similar to Mythic Legions. They're like if Mythic Legions and Stormcross. So I picked up a few more that I haven't obviously opened yet. I don't know that I'm going to open on this video, but we will open soon. That guy looks really, really nice. Then I had this Frieza come in. I think this was a GameStop pre-order when they were having like 30% off a pre-order. So this is the fourth form Frieza, the big Dragon Ball. And I also had this Golden Axe Death Adder, Seamless Body Big Storm. Picked him up because he looks like he'll fit in just perfectly with Mythic Legions. Now also, where did Kaya go? Come here, Kaya. We had a package come in from our friends Cody in Brooklyn, who you met for the first time in Nashville, and they sent a prize for Kaya.
Oh, yay. Ooh, another Venom for the collection.
I think this is Scream.
That's exciting.
Symbiote. So, Cody, if you haven't seen Foxy for Real, he's selling all his Marvel Legends. He's still got a bunch for sale, and he sent that for the kiddo.
Thank you.
I think that was the only one you're missing of the symbiotes that have been released so far.
Yeah, I think so, because it was that one and the Punisher, but we got the Punisher one.
Do you want to cosplay as that? So, thanks to Cody and Brooklyn for sending us
the
kiddo.
Thank you.
And we do have one other thing. Hold on. So then also recently, David and I bought a collection from William. I won't say your last name because you may not want that for privacy, but William. And we picked up a bunch of his Marvel Legends and stuff that you can see in Double D Collectibles. Mercari page on our Facebook page. I don't know if David has it all listed yet. But he said, thank you for buying my Marvel Legends collection. I'm reading this note he sent. I have included some oversized Pokemon cards and promo cards along with energy cards for older Pokemon sets, and some coins and pins, and a bunch of Pokemon sleeves for Kaya. Hope she enjoys the Pokemon item. So, William, thank you very much. And now we're going to see... Oh, I've just covered up with my hand!
So, you have this prizes.
Okay.
Prizes. Are you excited to see what they are?
Yes, I am.
I think there's going to be energy. Oh, those might be promos.
Oh.
A variety of stuff.
Oh, those are cool.
Oh, yeah.
Awesome. Let's
pull a few of them out, show the good folks at home. Some energies.
Pull out some random. Ooh, there's a bunch of promos. That looks cool.
Yeah, it does look cool. That's
nice.
Yeah,
these are all promos. It's really cool.
And then this looks like, oh, you'll like this. Look at all these pins. You're going to like that. Pins and coins and all right. Chips.
These are all energy cards.
Energy. And this is a humongous amount of sleeves. So these are from like ETBs, I bet. And they're like the theme sleeves.
Oh, that's cool.
Which is great. And then he sent a bunch of big cards. Look at those big cards.
Snorlax.
Yeah.
Oh, these are cool.
You probably don't have any of these because I think they're older. Oh, a Charizard.
I don't know. I don't think we have any of like the EX series.
Yeah, I don't think so because those are older.
Oh, these are cool.
Those are cool. So
really cool.
Prizes for Kaya today. Can you say thank you, William?
Thank you so much, William.
And Cody,
these are
and Brooklyn.
Awesome.
Yeah. Wonderful.
Awesome.
Now, what we're going to definitely try to accomplish tonight is to get this skateboard sign and the Sailor Pluto Pop sign. Are we excited for that, Natalie? She's excited. So, Sailor, that will wrap up the skateboard for now. And then we may get Bulma and Sue signed tonight. Maybe. Depends if her... If her line is long, we'll save it for tomorrow. Ice Machine on film, that's good. And if her line's really short, we may just knock it out. Because last year, Chris Sabat's line was super duper long.
Yeah.
So we'll see. We'll play that by ear. Because Victoria may want to meet her too, which doesn't mean we can't do it tomorrow. And then I'm going to get three signatures on this board. I'm going to get Judith Hogue to sign it. I'm going to get Francois Show. I don't know how to pronounce his name. That played Shredder in Turtles 2. Regular Shredder, not Super Shredder. And he was in Lost. And Pierre Chang in Lost at that. And that tempts me to get like some sort of Lost thing. I don't know what to do. And then the suit actor. So this is the suit and voice for Turtles 1. The suit actor for Turtles 2 is there. And who else is there? Brian is there as well, but I already have his signature there, Leonardo, for 1, 2, and 3. So we're going to get three turtle signatures on this. So that should be good, don't you think?
Yeah.
So we're going to try to accomplish that. We're just going to be on there for a couple hours today, pick up our press passes and so forth, give you a quick look around. Tomorrow will be the longer, which is probably 15 minutes from now for you, with a longer view. I know In Your Face Art is there set up, so we'll try to spend some time talking to him. I don't know. It's down at Sheraton, Atlanta, so let's hit the road. See you there.
Where I've arrived at the Sheraton, Atlanta Hotel.
And now we have to find where things are.
Yep.
Where Sailor Pluto is.
Pluto! Keeper of time.
Is that gentleman?
Puppy?
Oh, puppy!
Yeah.
This looks like the right place, I think.
Yeah.
Some version of the right place. Hot pants?
Hot pants.
This feels right.
I see a Black Ranger.
Definitely right.
So these shirts are really cool. It has all the guests all on one shirt. I don't want to get copyrighted, but those are super cool. I like them.
Press pass in it. I'll give you a better rundown of everything tomorrow.
Hey,
what's up, dude?
How you doing?
Shout out to my man, but we are here to get things signed. So we're going to do a perusal and get things signed and get these boards out of our hand because we'll do a lot of this tomorrow. Goal tonight is get signatures.
So you got a bunch of guests, a bunch of stuff, But we're just gonna tour ourselves first, then we'll tour the good people later.
There's all of our turtle guests all right here, and a whole bunch of rages. Where's In Your Face? Where's Doug at? Oh, he's way down there now. We'll go say hi to him in a minute. A bunch of rangers, but we can get these signatures. There's Judith.
I like this year.
We can get these signatures knocked out very fast.
I'm going to knock these out.
So, we've got Brian already on here.
Ken and Judith. We're going to knock those out real fast like.
So, he signed right by a Shredder from the first movie. Now, I just got to remember, I've met Kevin Nash twice. I need to get him to sign this too, because he becomes Super Shredder after him
in the second movie.
Then I have all three. How wonderful is it to talk to him about Lost? I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do it tomorrow as well. So now we've met Brian. We're gonna meet Ken and get him to sign over here by Josh Pace, who is Raphael in the first one. Get him to sign that one. Then we're gonna go over there to the lovely Judith Hogue, and she can sign wherever she wants. If I'm honest with you, it don't matter. She's able. All right, off we go.
Wow.
Well, that was very cool. Shout out to Ken Scott. That was awesome. We got in the red for Raph. I love it. Spent a lot of time talking to us. He told us how in the first movie he does all the stunts and the martial arts and the ninja stuff. And in the second movie he's doing the acting stuff. It's very interesting when you learn about the history of those movies and like how hard it was to do that as practical effects.
How many different people played a part?
I think that's why modern, like the modern Ninja Turtle movie wasn't well received, because you got used to practical Jim Henson effects. And CG just doesn't do the same thing. He said four different people. Success.
Right in the middle.
Success. I am, yes.
I feel like Judith and I are just old friends.
Yes.
We learned that she and Brian Cranston, Walter White on Breaking Bad, are dear friends. And that the actor that plays Howard on Better Call Saul, which just had a very eventful episode, are also very good friends. I need to get a Howard Heisenberg April O'Neil piece of art.
Yes.
And although I doubt Brian Cranston. I would have to ask her to get the Brian Cranston. Oh, yeah, he can make it. I would have to get her to get the Brian Cranston signature, I believe. So thank you to Judith. Looks wonderful. Now it's time to meet Sailor Pluto. How does that make you feel?
Very excited.
Yes, and in your face already dried over there. And hopefully Bulma. Kai, what are you doing? Hot pants? Oh.
So we haven't. We're gonna go meet Sailor Pluto, but we got my man Doug right here in your face art.
Let's go.
We had the Big Doug promo code. This is great. Let me go over your booth in detail, because
if you see one you like, bro, show you.
Oh, you are the man. Got that. Let's see what we're working with. We got Golden Freezer. So you see, he's got a great setup. Oh, I'm sorry. He's got all his stuff out there. And you see me wearing all this stuff all the time. I think that Bleach shirt is really cool. But this is a great display where you can see all of his stuff. And he also has these prints. So right now, well, I'll put this on Instagram, but he's got a 15% off code in 613. Now we'll be done by then. He's got art. Ooh, that's cool. That you like that one with Boo and Oob? That'd be cool. I would love that as a shirt. We got the Girl Power. So he's got prints, he's got shorts now, leggings. He just put up new shorts, Boo, and this Blue All-Stars shorts. I've been kickboxing in them. They are great. He's got the Boo hoodie. That's my very favorite thing. So these are the all-over prints. But then he has, does he have any of the regular print shirts? I think these are all the all-over stuff. You got Pokemon. Is that Nezuko, I think? Boo.
Yeah.
Do you see anything you want? You say you can pick something out. I'm sure there's something up there you want. Which, do you have all the Demon Slayer?
I don't have.
There's a Tanjiro. There's a Zenitsu. There's a Borboy.
And Tanjiro.
There's also Cell. Well, just look around. There's the Tanjiro. I like that Tanjiro. I actually don't have that one. So, let me see if Doug wants to talk a little bit. Tell you about the business. I like that Bleach shirt. That shirt is cool. I've never seen it, don't know anything about it, but the shirt is slap booty nasty. So we love my man, dog. Make sure you support him.
Yep.
So what do they need to know about In Your Face?
In Your Face is in your face, man. That's what you need to know. No, man. I love doing the work, man. We sell art that's in your face. Bright, beautiful colors, man. The guys, we like bright colors too, man. All the kids and the ladies, the section just be bright colors, dope designs, and we get a square.
Yeah, nothing. Just a little logo.
Navy blue, black, gray, white. So we want to add some colors and some flavors to our artwork, and we want to show people how much we love our anime. I don't cosplay. You cosplay?
I don't.
This is how we cosplay, man. Yep. In Your Face, you already know what it is. Big Dub in the building, man. What's up?
All of this, you draw yourself.
Yep.
And then you figure out the layout and all that action.
Yeah, man, on the iPad Pro, man. So what?
Procreate.
Yeah. Yeah, man. I want to get into Adobe Illustrator so I can get those vectors down pat. But so this is what I tell people when it comes to making designs. I draw what I like, what my supporters like, and what my competition is making. That's what I draw, and that's how I do it.
So I know the question I get the most.
Okay.
When we gonna see a little
maybe a little Venom or some of that realm of stuff. Disney gonna come after.
Listen, I'm about to. I don't care. They gangster, we gangster. I got Disney stuff coming. I got Nickelodeon stuff coming. Cartoon Network stuff coming. Way more than Dragon Ball. I only got a couple more Dragon Ball pieces I'm doing, and I'm off Dragon Ball for like 2 months because everybody is loving my work.
I'm trying to think what I need. Oh, you know what I want. I want the one that has all the Gokus, and you're like, man, I'm gonna spend 30 hours drawing that.
I can do it though. How you doing?
Be slap booty nasty.
Yeah, I can do that. So, if I do the Gokus, man, it's going to be everything from Kid Goku, Kaioken.
All, like the history of Goku.
The whole history.
Well, you don't have a Kaioken, really, do you?
Nope, I don't even have a Kaioken.
Oh, he has. Because he's got a bunch.
So much, I'm a big Dragon Ball fan, but everybody is like, y'all know it. You got a whole bunch of Dragon Ball. We want to see One Piece, and we want to see Seven Deadly Sins, Fairy Tail. So I'm going to be doing a lot more other stuff than what I'm doing
right now. And go follow In Your Face on Facebook. And I will say, those of you that have used a promo code and bought stuff or have seen my stuff, when he posts his things on Facebook, there's a whole bunch of people that always post, if this is real, I'll buy it right now.
Yeah, man. There's a lot of fake stuff. Yeah.
Because a lot of fake stuff looks like this, but it's completely real. So leave him reviews, comments on his thing.
Yeah, man.
Because he's the man. He's one of us. He's one of us.
I don't blame you guys because I see it a lot myself. You'll see somebody take like a regular image and it'll look like the whole thing.
They'll just skew it.
But yeah, they skew it, so it's not the real deal. That's why I do the video to show you the actual real joint, man. This is real. It's here. It's in your face.
And he's got the tanks and the shorts. I've been kickboxing in those. That's where I
see. And the leggings are very, very comfortable.
My love, these guys have been supporting me so much, man. I can't do this without you guys. So before y'all leave, I got three things I'm about to give y'all, okay? Hold on.
Ooh. It's a secret. I don't know what's about to happen here. I don't know. About to whip out. Oh. We love my man Doug. Obviously, I wear his stuff all the time and everywhere. He's rocking the pump too. I'm gonna have to wear my kicks tomorrow. Oh, dude, that's them limited edition joint too.
Brand new, man. I just made them.
That's awesome. That's awesome. That's awesome. And I noticed you got the pumps.
See, oh, yeah, man. We got to bring
We just came up here for preview night to knock this stuff out. We'll be back tomorrow. I got to wear my J's tomorrow. What kind of J's you want to see me in?
Man, I'm a fan of the Jordan 1s, man. Wonder I'm ones. A big Jordan 1
right.
fan,
we can wear some 1s tomorrow. She got the dunks on.
Oh, yeah. Oh, damn. Yeah. Cool. Yeah.
You
know, we got
to keep it fresh.
You know, I'm customizing a pair right now. I'm customizing. And I don't customize no more. Please don't inbox me. Oh, man, do me shoes. I don't do shoes anymore. But the blue all-star shirt, I'm making a matching pair of dunks to match.
That's
dope.
That's dope. That's dope.
Yes.
So, thanks, brother. Hey, I appreciate you, man.
Yep. See, there you go.
Wonderful to meet my man, Doug. But we're going to come meet the voice of Sailor Pluto, and Natalie's excited. Are we pleased?
I'm very, 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 very pleased. My cheeks hurt from smiling. She is
there
so
was
nice.
Nothing on that skateboard like a month ago. And look at all these signatures.
It's wonderful.
What to say? I believe in you. Pluto power. All right, last stop. Voice of Bulma, voice of Froppy. If she just left, hopefully she comes back. We're going to go find out. Say hot pants.
Hot pants.
Woo. So Monica Rell, the voice of Bulma, the voice of Froppy, is our last signature. We've got an hour before the show closes today, and we'll have done all of our signatures for the show, which is great. That way, if Victoria wants to meet Jason David Frank tomorrow, the Green and White Ranger, or Froppy, or Bulma, whoever, we can wait in line with her, and we don't have to carry around skateboards all day. So she went to take a break real quick. She'll be back in like 15 minutes. We'll knock that out, and continue on and on we go. We haven't really looked around at all, but I do shout out to my man Doug, In Your Face Art. You got a little overview of his booth. You got to hear from him some. He's going to have Disney stuff coming soon and just take them on. So we'll probably run. As soon as there's some more of that, we'll run another promo code. He's got a promo code running right now. I'll talk about it on Instagram if that help you. But it's been great. We're knocking out stuff. And meeting people. How was meeting Sailor Pluto? All these scouts that you've met, who's the favorite one you've met? You're not going to answer that question. Is it the kitty cat?
He was very nice. Pluto and the singing voice of Sailor Moon.
Very, very nice.
Very, very
Yeah, so she's out. She's actually talking to In Your Face Art. She's out in front of her booth. You see Doug right there. That's her. Out in front of her, in front of the booth, talking to people, having a good time. I love this show, Ranger Stop. It's a good show. I like it. Kaya gets to be Froppy. She's just been waiting for us, but we usually are waiting for her. So it's a change of pace. It's nice. Hot chicken.
Hot chicken.
While we wait for Bulma to come back, should we play the... there's the Hot Wheels mystery box, the Office mystery box, Toy Story mystery box, Imaginarium Toys and Mystery. No, no casino tonight. So Kaya was asking me, she saw the monster booth. She's like, do they just give away monsters? Which is often the case at cons. If you look around, there'll be somebody giving away energy drinks because it's promotion. Kaya, guess what? They are just giving away monsters. Peachy Monster. Well, poop long and prosper. Trying not to film much until tomorrow, but those Rainland graphics, my man's got some heat. Of course, we're looking at the Sailor Moon, and it's printed on glass. It's so nice. We have a lot of the lenticular, but I don't think we have that. It's beautiful. All right, finally, we're back here to meet Bulma. Monica Real. Are you excited to meet Bulma or Froppy? Who are you more excited for? It's the same person. And what else? And other things? Lots of things. Lots of things. Bulma and Froppy. We're going to get our pop sign. One for me, one for the kiddo. Well, that was just wonderful. Yeah. I got this with all or a lot of our characters.
Yes.
We probably spent 10 minutes with Bulma and Sue. That made me very happy. I love Vegeta sometimes. And the winky face. All right. It's time for us to get out of here and come back tomorrow, yeah?
Yes.
Did we have fun?
Yes.
So day one. We're only there. That's 8:15. I mean, we were there like 3 hours almost, which I didn't think we'd be there that long, but
everybody was so friendly. Nice.
I mean, like every voice actor we met, it was like they knew us.
Yeah.
And we spent extended time.
And they were telling us all like little, they're like, you didn't hear this from me, but.
Yeah. Good things, positive things in the world of things that if specifically Dub cares about. Positive things. Well, that's my hint. My hint that the things that are the most in my wheelhouse, positive news. We had a very good time. Very good time. And we just looked around a little bit. We did pick up a little bit of art. I mean, that glass Sailor Moon thing was too good, and I didn't want it to be gone. Because it wasn't that busy tonight. I think it'll be a little busier tomorrow. They give away a lot of free tickets, so I expect it to be full.
And Inuvae's art, shout out to him. I mean, he gave us some art, too.
Yeah, he gave us some art, gave us some stuff. Yeah. Certainly not expected, dog. I mean, very generous. We are more than happy to pay full price for everything, because your stuff's awesome.
It's amazing.
That was cool to get a little kind of combo with him. You know, a little behind the scenes. So he said he told us about a Batman shirt that he's currently working on. So I think you'll see some superhero stuff soon, which I'm sure a lot of you will be into. His art's incredible.
Yes.
And we'll probably get Victoria some tomorrow, I believe.
He's just got a bunch of new stuff in his inventory.
What was your favorite part of the tonight coming? All of it.
Yes, that's my favorite part.
Was it when we met the guy that wore the suit for Raphael and Ninja Turtles 2 and he talked to you about the puppeteers?
I thought that was interesting.
I thought it was actually really interesting too.
Was it when the Bulma voice actress did the Froppy voice for you? I liked that very much. The voice for another anime, which I liked. I liked her. Yeah. She was really nice.
She was very, very nice. I mean, we got to spend 15 minutes with her. And that's the advantage. So a tip I'll give you. You saw Kai and I do it at MomoCon. These shows that are multi-day but have like a half day, like later in the evening hours, the opening night, go that night for your signatures. Because her line has an overflow spot. And there's only a couple signature people that they're planning overflow lines. I think her line will be very, very busy tomorrow. And we got to spend 15 minutes with her, where tomorrow that's just probably not possible.
Same thing with Sailor Pluto. She had an overflow line, too, because she's the voice of Ash from Pokemon, which is big, you know. She did the first 8 seasons of Pokemon.
Yeah,
she
was the voice
of Ash, so.
So, go on, like, these things, if you got signatures you want to get, which a lot of people are asking me in these recent videos, like, oh, that looks cool, that looks fun. One of the things we're doing is we own too much stuff. Like, and... You know that I try to make my collection unique and not collect as much like mass Walmart stuff anymore. But this is a way you can make it truly unique, is to get your own personalized autographs, have the experience to meet them, Plus, you get like, we're getting the skateboards, like weird things signed, which makes it truly you. Like, I think every time I've got that skateboard signed, and I know every time Natalie's got her signed, it's the only one they've ever signed, or the only one they've signed in a long time, or whatever. So, I mean, that's cool. Makes it unique. So we're gonna go home now. So that's my advice. Thanks to Ranger Stop, they had us out, press passes. They also gave a bunch of free tickets away. We had free tickets to give away. We're gonna give them to our friends tomorrow because none of you claimed them, which is fine. But
or for our friends and family.
Yeah, I guess so. But you know, if
we would always love to have you guys come out and join us, though.
Yep, and we appreciate Ranger Stop for giving us some to give away, just like ICCC did. Lots of people supporting the beat up fit thing. So we're thankful to them. Tomorrow I plan to give you a really detailed look at the show. I'm not going to separate this into two videos like I did for MomoCon because I don't think it's big enough. And we don't have any other plans really this weekend except seeing Jurassic Park tomorrow. So kind of booth by booth, really highlight the vendor themselves if they want to talk. Let them talk. And just show you some of the different things that are there. So really, I think what a lot of people have mentioned with all of our cons that we're doing recently is I don't realize how many people don't have access to cons.
Yes.
That, you know, we're spoiled living in a big city like Atlanta. We have a con frequently. And then we can drive to Birmingham or Chattanooga or Knoxville or Nashville.
Charlotte.
Augusta, Greenville. Columbia, Charlotte. All day trips. And so we get access to all this stuff that a lot of people don't. So I really want to give you the con experience tomorrow, show you all the booths a little bit more detail, all that kind of stuff. So look forward to that tomorrow. We'll have Victoria with us. We'll have James with us. I think James will probably meet Bulma. I would guess that'll happen. I think Victoria will too. Victoria may meet the Green Ranger. That's she was hot for Tommy before she was hot for Hopper.
Yeah.
But Victoria's at the house. She's got the puppy. We'll chat it up with her when we get home. I'm going to grill some burgers for us when we get home and, you know, ride out. You know what I'm talking about?
Ride out, Clyde.
Yeah, we grilling it. Out in the backyard grilling. Grilling it up. Just four quick burgers. We're just going to have some chips burgers because it's late. It's 9 o'clock and we got to get up and do it all over again. Victoria's here. The puppy's here. We got some Kobe beef burgers that Natalie picked up. So excited for that. I think them things look pretty doggone good myself.
I've heard of
them in my life. Burgers. Who's excited for burgers?
I am.
Who's excited to go to Ranger Stop tomorrow?
I am.
Rufus has got to take a break while we eat because these burgers are juicy, huh, Rufus?
It's the burgers.
All right. We'll talk to you in the morning on the way to Ranger Stop part two.
Yeah.
Somebody say hot chicken.
Hot chicken.
You?
I was thinking it was more like hot beef.
Oh.
Juicy burgers.
Oh. Actually, before bed, I'll show you. We got that put right back up where it came from. And that's the animated one. I think that looks really good up there.
Other accessories are in the cabinet.
Other accessories in the cabinet. So Kaya made me these models. These are the flame toys. That's Storm Shadow and Snake Eyes. And they're just sitting here in her craft room temporarily because she's also built the bikes. It's a Storm Shadow's bike. I don't know what that piece is. And Snake Eyes bike. So she's built those, but she's going to weather them up. Put a little dirt, grime, and what have you. And I think they look good. So I want to show you that. But now, time for bed. Talk to you tomorrow. Rufus, can you say good morning to the people? Rufus? Okay. Rufus has a water buffalo ear that he's enjoying. Rufus. Can you say good morning? Welcome to day two? No? Rufus! He ain't getting them away from that water buffalo's ear. Woke up early to spend some time with the puppy. Hey, buddy.
You big froth ball. You bird got your belly. I got your belly.
He don't care. As long as he can chew on that water buffalo's ear, and you can see my kneecap, he is in heaven.
He is in the heaven.
You want the ball? Hey, you want the ball? Go get it. Oh, he just snatched it. Here. No, he's out. Let's try that again, buddy. Go get it. Trying to work that doo-doo out. Trying to work that doo-doo out. Rufy. Good boy. Go, Kaya. Oh, that kind of, I don't know what. Do that again.
No.
Do you have neck joint articulation?
I can't even actually do what you were just doing.
There's that.
She looks like one of the Goombas from the live action Mario movie where they're like swaying in the elevators. Oh,
are you Goomba?
I don't know that I've noticed that.
Would you like it? Was it John Leguizamo? Who was it?
Yes,
would you like it if John Leguizamo jumped on your head?
No.
Well, we're headed to Ranger Stop. Oh, we're not at Ranger Stop. We're at Marco's Pizza? Is that where we're going? Choco Latte? Well, we're having a coffee. That's what we're actually doing. I choose you.
Victoria, you getting that cookie?
Maybe.
She was lusting over it. Is that cookie delicious?
Is it like a Reese's?
She was lusting.
It's a Reese's peanut butter cup one.
Yeah. Oh. Are we here for what made us famous? Devilish and divine?
What?
Is that what we're here for?
What?
Devilish and divine?
Uh-huh.
Oh. Write your favorite inspirational quote to spread positivity. Well, I like that board. Let's see what they are. All things are possible. Love like you've never been hurt before. Let's see.
Okay, I have a milk-based extreme care.
Don't sweat the petty things. Don't fret the sweaty things. See, that's telling you you need to do more Ring Fit Adventure. That's what that's saying. And don't get worked up just because you struggled with a model for a little while. Set your heart ablaze.
This is from Demon Slayer.
Oh. You think that's the first time it was ever used?
No, but they say it a lot in Demon Slayer.
Ah. You think that's the entrance to the mines of Moria?
I think it's a rainbow.
Oh. Hope you are a giver. Remember to have one, that's because the takers don't have any. Well, I wouldn't say that's necessarily positivity. I mean, that's decent advice, but I don't think that's really inspirational. It's just a cautionary tale.
We are all in
today we will live in the moment. Unless the moment is unpleasant, then we will eat a cookie. Cookie Monster. I think that's good. Yesterday I was clever. All I wanted to change to hug your neighbor. Do you think that's what Rufus is doing when he's barking at the dogs? He just wants to go hug them.
Yeah.
Oh.
He sounds like he's got vengeance in his voice.
That's true. He doesn't like them. All right, I gotta go, TT. How we doing? I got a beef patty. I got a latte. With macadamia nut milk. I've never had that. And Irish. They all got juicy, juicy caramel delights. Montaya has an actual Oreo in her drink. I'm jealous of that.
Extreme caramel.
Yep. They're pretty, relatively healthy. For the froth. Ron, for the froth. And a Jamaica beef patty. What did you just get? Cookie?
I didn't know, but that was chocolate.
Chocolate croissant? What did you get?
I got a New York
crumb cake.
Ice muffin.
Everybody else's sounds better than mine, but I'm trying to be good. Come here, let's see. Oh, the frog. Oh, that's actually delicious. We are back inside. Visit floors 1-3, exhibit room, celebrities, autographs, and so much more. So, what I need to do today is try to give you a general feel for where things are at. VIP seating reserved. So this must be a panel room. Yeah, it's a panel room. Panels and parties. So if you have the VIP ticket, you get front row seating. I don't know if any of that's going on. I don't think the convention itself is open formally for, well, 3 more minutes. Santa? Then I'm going to walk down here. We've seen, oh, that's where the professional photos would be. So if you want to buy photos and get them taken with a professional camera with a nice backdrop, that's where that is, which is nice that it's separate from the vendor hall so that this line can take up all this space and doesn't crowd. A lot of times those photo ops are in the walkways or whatever of the vendor hall, which makes everything really congested. And then down here, I think this is just the general lobby. Yeah, this is the, I know where I'm at, because this is the hotel for Dragon Con. It's like you turn there and you go, oh, yep, there's those stairs that take you up to the big panel rooms. So this is just the lobby. You can hear the noise starting to emerge from up there, which we may go up those stairs this time, find our way around. But this is just the Sheraton's, like, snack section and Atlanta memorabilia and what have you. So, like, when you come for Dragon Con, This area is always popping out in front. There'll be food trucks here. This is the hotel you actually get your badge at Dragon Con, down the side over there. And there will be all sorts of vendors and such in here. So this hotel is nice. I see a Black Ranger. So there's probably nothing over there except check-in for the hotel. But here's your Ranger stop. Imagine, see, a ton of guests. An absolute ton of guests this year at the show, which is awesome. And this is for, this is November. This is the show in Orlando at the SeaWorld DoubleTree. Presents Collector Stop, a con within a con. Two shows in one. Well, that may be cool. When is this? November 11th. So let's see who's here. Rangers. Black Ranger. A ton of Ranger guests, of course, because it is a Ranger stop. April. Oh, Ernie Reyes. That's an autograph that we don't have. It's a Kino, right? It's a turtle autograph we don't have, and a bunch of coming soon. So with them having those two guests, makes me believe there's going to be more turtles coming to this show as well. So we can go up there, which is the way we will go, as soon as I find the ladies. What's up, Raphael? Oh, there's the girls. I've found the girls. Kahoo! Louder! Everyone's like, what is happening here?
Here's this. There's us. There's all of our peoples. There's all of our peoples. There's all of our peoples.
Oh, safety. You disappeared.
I did.
You win.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hello.
Are you excited?
I am.
Are you going to meet the Green Ranger, White Ranger?
Touch
him on his bottom. He's here. Jason Frank's here. Touch him on his bottom. What if he's into that thing? What if it's free if you do that?
If he requests it.
Oh, that's what Victoria wants to do. Touch Jason David Frank on his bottom. You used to want to do that.
So where am I going from here?
This way.
Okay.
Let's go.
If he was something else you guys cared about, because he's a lot of things.
TB, Midwest number one provider of Smash Brothers. Oh, see, this is much easier than however we got here before. Is this considered floor two? Floor one. This is where we get our tickets.
You already have yours, though, right?
Say hot chicken. But Victoria and you, y'all need to get them.
Well, I can hang out with Victoria if you guys want
to. Oh, I don't think I have anything else to do. We can't get anything anyway.
Oh, is it not open yet?
Maybe, but we have to go through the metal detector one way or another. Are you going? So you might meet the White Ranger. It's possible. Look at James Bob. Oh!
So you see that, if I remember right, they have a live stream on their Facebook page that they do all day. They bring guests up there. So that'll happen, which is cool. And dude, I am contemplating getting one of these shirts before we go. I think the shirt is really cool because it has like all the different characters that are here. I think that's a cool idea. I guess other cons do that, just don't pay attention as much, but I like that. Are you going to get the Ranger Stop mystery box? She's out. Come on, Cindy. No, you got to be on that side. I can't see you. Come on. Everybody say hot pants.
Hot pants.
Oh, it's a video. All right. So I did learn this morning that there is press availability for some of the guests. Like there was at MomoCon. So I'm going to try to do that. So we might hop back and forth, but I'm going to try to show you every single booth. And if they have information, so you can see their information and cover it all for the con. So let's begin.
There's a bookstore vendor. It has a lot of stuff.
We do have some.
I don't know anything about it, but let me show you. Trump Master Press. Out of Birmingham. I'm not getting out of focus here. See their information. Lots of different books. Yes, all of this. I guess this is everything that this publisher puts out. This is their Instagram link.
Historical fiction.
I'm not familiar with any of it. But some of these covers look cool. I need to read more. Get a free ebook if you follow on Instagram.
Follow us on Instagram. Yeah. Get a free ebook.
Well, that's free is always good. Rejects Club. So let's see. Armin Shimerman's Illyria Book One, Betrayal Ranger. I don't know anything about it, but I'd like to support that. So Imaginarium, Toys and Mystery. whatnot. I don't imagine there's a lot of things that have that name. I don't know that they're going to have any Instagram. But they've got balls. Oh, look at this. The Black Gate of Mordor set. This Toy Biz. Exclusive Mouth of Sauron figure. $200. Minion. Who's James the Victor? I don't know what they're doing.
Number five. I would like to find that expensive My Hero Pop somewhere
to get it signed, but once again, I think that's going to be a losing venture. So they got a million stickers, but they have all these mystery boxes, which is not the where you really want to go. Well, they have old systems. Fantastic. Beetle Bailey mystery box. Angry Birds. I think even smaller mystery boxes. We got Junkyard Dog. LJN, Fartus. I could easily see myself grabbing one of these just for fun before we leave. California Raisins mystery box. So they have a lot. A lot. Imaginarium mystery. Like that. Like that. That could end up happening. Do a little walk and talk. A little walk and talk. I think this is the side of that booth. Yeah. Apologies if you can't hear me as well. Oh, there's a Bob Ross. So what do we got? Help the Health and Wellness Zone. Energy drinks. Energy drinks and hydration drinks. I don't know if you purchase that or if that's being given away.
It's morphin' time!
Oh, it's morphin' time. I'm sure that happens repeatedly through the day.
Is their website.
Pins, Ahsoka.
Oh, I like those pins.
Those 3D printed?
Yeah.
Oh, right there, yeah. Obviously.
And that would be
Casey Mask.
Yeah, okay.
Is that a pop socket?
No, it's actually just a Ranger coin.
Oh, it's a Ranger coin. That's cool.
Yeah.
So they're just 3D printing right here on the spot. It's a lot of interesting things.
Website. Outer Rim. Out of Rim merch.
Super tight.
Cool pins.
Super
dope. Star Wars stuff.
I'll just give you all
like a Shredder, Rocksteady, Bebop, Krang. Be fun to paint those. This is Timberee 3D. I guess this is also. There's their QR code if you want that. Timberee 3D. It might be all the same. Oh, this stuff is all 3D? I don't feel like it. This just looks like figures. Probably the thrones are 3D printed. I'm not completely sure what I'm looking at. That's kind of cool. Yeah. Pulling around a thing. Yeah, thrones. Different little accessories. Dragons. We certainly prefer humpies.
And then you see on the outside is where you get all the celebrity guests, which I showed you yesterday, but I'll go slow as I encounter them. So you can see the guests are here. What's up, dude?
What's up, man?
Long time no see.
Hello.
How you doing?
Hey.
Hey.
Saved by the Bell, Abraham Rodriguez, Perez, Jordan Fight. So lots of, obviously you're going to see tons of Lightning Collection. And the old, like, Bandai America, like that. Toys here. Is that a graded Megazord? Timberee 3D. Jordan Fight. Chance Perez. Francois Show. Brian Toshi's not there yet. There's Judith. Somehow I never recorded us talking to her yesterday. I just showed you that we had a signature. But, all right, that's the end of row one.
So I got to pay attention because I do want to get to that press conference. It's in 20 minutes. So I think I can get down row two before I got to go.
This booth, I don't think they have any social media. I'll just show you the social media for like artists and unique things. And a bunch of, I mean, it just looks like a big Target Walmart, honestly. A lot of widely available things. You're fine. A bunch of pops. I need to see if there's a...
Sorry.
No, you're fine, man. Mortal Kombat. Dragon Stars, Fortnite. Anything unique there? Violator. The Thing. There's April. Probably have that for people to get signed, even though it's not the correct April.
You don't know that they're My Little Pony.
Over here.
Let's see. So the pop, the My Hero pop I need would be in a pop protector. Almost sure. Oh, a Grishnik. That's cool. I do not think that will be at this booth. And they have some slabs. Ranger stuff. Super 7. Lots of slabs. Oh, a fair amount. Not very good prices.
It's the Hotto pop I need. She's the one of the big three, and she's here. But that's expensive.
Those prices aren't good at that booth anyway. So we will not be purchasing there.
We do have some of the exclusives, the recent stuff. I imagine they're not. Yeah, $300. Maybe that's for the set. Still, that's pretty steep. Pizza Monster. Yeah. Certainly all at the con pricing.
That's cool, though. That's autographed.
I think that's a different booth. We'll go there in a minute.
Because you got this sticker booth or decals. I don't think that's an artist themselves. So nothing. That's just a decal seller.
So no social media to show you from that.
Hey.
What you doing?
Found a booth that wants to take all of my money, past, present, and future.
Is it the wood booth?
Yes.
That has lots of good stuff?
Lots and lots and lots, yes.
Past, present, and future?
Yes, yes.
Oh, well, that's interesting. All I'll have to money. See what that ends up being. How? Why is that? Is it because you want the Los Pollos Hermanos drink cup that I don't see anymore? Did it go away?
Maybe somebody bought it.
There was a Los Pollos Hermanos drink
that's
cup.
That's fun.
Oh, there it is. Yes. Yes.
Yeah, you guys did yesterday. Look at it.
Yes. Oh, yeah, they have the Zelda mystery sack full of Zelda items. It's quite a thing. Rare Zelda items. Rare Marvel Legends. Let's see what we got. I'm not going to show you guys as much of like the figure stuff because you just see this at every show. I want to show you the more unique things. This is the side of the mystery box. Oh. You're fine. Item. Then we do have some I didn't see Mario's comics after we've seen him over and over again. So big comic booth. Rebel Base. I think that's out of North Carolina. I think. I feel like I've been to that show. I don't know. Kent Poole, is that out of North Carolina?
They could potentially have the big pop I need. It would be like way up there.
Is that a headless Ned Stark?
I think it is. I'm going to zoom in. Yeah, $1,500. That's a very elusive pop. Headless Ned Stark.
I remember when I collected pops, that was the only Game of Thrones pop I didn't have at the time I stopped collecting pops. It was that Headless Ned Stark. It's pretty limited. That's crazy.
I was thinking of things to get double signed. That would be cool. You could get Amy Jo Johnson and Judith Hope to sign that, and the Yellow Ranger, and a Mikey thing. You'd get four signatures on those little labs. That'd be kind of neat.
See what else I have. Anything else here? Probably nothing we need here. So this is the booth Victoria's talking about. Like, I'm sure she loves that. The Walking Dead.
Hogwarts, she probably likes that a lot.
A lot of these things, a lot of Harry Potter stuff in these. I like these wood things. That E.T.'s very nice. Let me see if they have a social media or an online store, because this is stuff you can't find every day. It's a pretty big. Oh, they have a Butterbeer sign. It's pretty big. Oh, here we go. Let me show you. Let's see. Here we go. I have found it. Loftus Woodworking. And it does have Instagram, Etsy. So they have an Etsy store. That's good. Because this is cool stuff. This is the stuff to go to shows for, to see these kinds of unique things that you're not going to find on Amazon or Walmart. Whatever. That really is pretty.
Hufflepuff is very nice.
Mudblower. This is a lot of Harry Potter.
Small. Such a Doctor Who. It's bigger on the inside. It's funny.
Oh, that's nice. Stained glass window.
So there's some artists. Or a artist. Like this stuff. We talked to him for a while last night, too.
I don't see his signage. Maybe he's just selling prints. I don't know.
You can get April signed.
Lots of turtle stuff. Any NECA figure, you're going to get the fact that they had to buy it from either Walmart or Target, so you get that markup. Plus, you get the markup that you're at a show, so it's not going to be positive. Freeze-dried candies. Shaking it. What kind of candy is that?
That's a Skittle.
Calamity.
Hold on. It's a Skittle? Yes. He's going to dump it in my hand. Freeze-dried Skittle. Is it delicious? Yes. That is delicious.
You make all this yourself?
I do.
That's old. Yes. Meteors. We're going to have to pick some of this up, I believe, before we leave.
21st century technology.
21st century?
Yes.
Is there peanut butter M&M's in here? Or Reese's?
Cannot do with honey, peanut butter, or chocolate because the water is emulsified within it. So when you try to pull it out, you're not left with anything.
It's not there anymore.
These work only because there's a shell.
Okay.
So the shell kind of holds the chocolate, but the chocolate itself doesn't freeze dry. Just the caramel inside.
So it's because it's candy coated. It prevents, or yeah.
Yeah, we do M&M's, but then the chocolate, I mean, not M&M's, Milk Duds.
Yes.
But the chocolate just kind of flakes off.
It's just the malt.
Right, just the malt.
Pretty good.
Yeah.
Freeze dried Bitto honey.
Now, because that's not real honey.
It's whatever Bitto honey is that's
right,
not honey.
Right. But it tastes like honey and it's awesome.
The fruit's probably very good.
Yeah, the fruit's delicious.
We're going to have to pick some of this up on our way out. Or maybe for a snack in the middle of the day. Awesome. Thank you very much. That's cool. We'll have to get some of that. More of this wood. This wood has a massive, they have half of this row. Just a guy who loves anime. He got these things. Oh, these were here yesterday. Let me walk over here. So that looks like a Mythic Legion to me right there. But see, these kind of, I don't even know how you, like, this may open and be like a jewelry box, but they're kind of like diorama, just display pieces. They're cool. I love appreciating people's art like that. So then over here you see we got Sailor Pluto, the voice of Ash, and the voice of, I can't remember what Eric's doing, the other guy from Pokemon. Lindsay, that's the pop. I'd love to get signed if I can find it. We got Denki from My Hero, but he doesn't have a pop yet. That's the only reason we're not getting his signature today, because we're only getting pop signed. And then Bulma's over there with nobody in her line. Maybe she's not doing autographs yet. So these guys, I don't know if they have social media, because I don't think they sell online, but he's got a bunch of stuff you can get signed by people. Of course, but they print on demand, so some of them they have ready. We have a lot of their art. We have that. I can't even show you all. We have a lot of it, but then you can look through these posters, right? They've got all these portfolios. These are all books, and they print it for you on demand at that printer, and it prints out and looks just like this. It's actually remarkable. It only takes like 2 or 3 minutes. Or top shelf. We got a lot of their art. I love that, the way that digital art pops. Plus, you can get it printed and immediately get it signed. In some cases. What we doing?
Oh, we were scoping out some things.
You want to show me all the wood things that you want?
Checking out some prices. Oh.
Show me a couple of the wood things you want before I got to go to the press conference.
Okay.
You want the One Piece? You want the Shredder?
No.
Just a girl who loves anime?
No.
Tonight We Fly with all the broom and the vacuum?
Oh, I like that one.
The Hogwarts?
I like...
The Baby Yoda Wingardium Leviosa. Leviosa.
Yes, I like the...
There's a really cool Hufflepuff one I saw that has colors.
There are multiple different sizes.
Yeah, that Hufflepuff that's like 3D and the H. Did you see this one?
Yeah.
That's cool.
Did you see that one, Brian?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. There are multiple ones that are...
Where is it?
There's the Always. Oh, yeah. There's one with one of my favorite movies.
I saw it.
Multiple, the
light, the darkness one.
The light, the lamp. Basically, all the Harry Potter things. There was something about Hagrid.
Which they have a lot of Harry Potter
things.
They
have Ollivander, Hagrid.
Yes. Yes?
Oh, look at that! Oh.
Which one? Did you see? Oh, this is the place that had a. Hold on, let me show you. Come with me. I saw this last night. Come with me, Vicky. Come with me. Everybody on Double Life, come with me as well. Come with me.
And you'll see a real... Nope. No, it's right here. It's not a dad bod. It's a father figure. That's funny. And that looks like a silhouette of me in the ooh la la pose.
Okay, I also feel that would be appropriate for Hopper.
That's
especially
true.
Especially seasons 1 through 3.
Oh, yeah, because he lost a lot of weight. I didn't realize he lost all that weight because it's been so many years. But did you see the thing?
I read, yeah.
How he wanted to film the flashbacks before because he said, I'm losing weight.
Yes.
And they're like, well, haven't wrote it yet.
Yeah, and so they had to use prosthetics to make his face look more full.
That Gryffindor is beautiful.
That is very beautiful.
The grill father. There's a lot of cool things here. Also, that freeze-dried candy the man is giving out samples as Skittles, they are delicious.
Really?
And he just taught me about it. It's very interesting. All right, I'm going to go to the press conference.
Okay.
And I'll come see you ladies in a minute. Kaya, did you try a freeze-dried Skittle? They're delicious. He's handing out free samples. Also, you might be able to eat it. So Kaya can't eat a lot of things because of her braces. They have a freeze-dried caramel explosion M&M. It won't be sticky and chewy.
Right.
Because it's freeze-dried.
Right.
So it'll be crunchy.
Oh,
yeah. You might be able to try it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Master has given Dobby a sock!
Dobby is free!
Well, I saw the plague mask, but Kyle was showing me, and I know I'm supposed to be at the press conference, but these little diorama things, Batman, Survivor, or Menace, and so the light pipes through it.
Flourishing bones.
That's Harry Potter, right?
Yeah, wait.
It's touching me on my bottom.
Hey.
Then it's got the Quidditch, but look at this, that's House Bannister.
Oh, wow.
It's from the back, too?
You can look down into the back.
Oh. Here, Kai, help me out. Oh, that's actually really cool.
It's also easy to do. I love Hal and Florian and a bunch of other things.
That is so... These things are very, very nice. Let me show you this one. This is the one Kai was showing me. The Lord of the Rings. Let me see if I can get the focus for you.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
If you are a friend and you speak the password... It's the speak, friend, and enter. It's the Mines of Moria. Look at Gollum. In there. And it's like the Eye of... That thing is actually really, really cool. I mean, that thing's about the size of my hand.
Yeah.
But there is so much detail. She's the same woodvendor.
She said they do, like, Diagon Alley as well and other things.
Oh, wow. And House Lannister. Is that the Iron Throne? Oh, it's the Lion of Lannister. All right, I really do need to go. But that's very cool. All
right, so... They say there is press availability, like there was last time. They sent me an email this morning with some of the information, so I gotta find where this place is. And the Turtles press conference starts in like 9 minutes, so hopefully I can find it.
This is the room, making room. Hey, this is the right room? Press room?
This is the press room, are you
pressed? Yes, ma'am.
All right.
Yay.
Yay.
So that is the right place. I'm learning, this is all very new. And I don't even know, many of my friends have got like this type of And it's just, does the con do it? Is this new with the cons? Usually we just get access, but I do a lot more of the other stuff than a lot of my buddies do. They just usually are shopping. So I got here 5 minutes before the thing started, but because I wasn't here and didn't tell them I was coming, which I didn't know I was supposed to, but it's because I'm not actually a member of the press. I'm just a YouTube channel. So the guests come in, they check in, and they say, all right, you know, like 30 minutes early, and say, do we have any press reporters here to talk to us? And if nobody's there, then they go make money, right? Go do their autographs, their pictures, because when they're doing that for free for the press, they're not making money at their booth, so they just go back to their fans, which is what they should do. So the four Turtles guests would have been here had I been here 20 minutes ago, probably 30 minutes ago, which I don't even know that we were in here yet 30 minutes ago, or if I had reserved an interview slot with them, which I didn't realize I could do. So now I know. I've learned that. I will do better for each of you and for me, honestly, because it's really cool. So I might, if Judith Hoag's table is not busy at all, there's a food truck out there. I may see if she wants to talk on camera since I missed it, because that's who I really wanted to talk to. But in like 45 minutes is Sailor Pluto, but the two Pokemon guests. So I told her, I got the press relations person, gave her my number. I said, I want to come. I'll be back here in time. It's in like an hour, so I'm going to come in like 30 minutes. I want to see if Kai wants to come with me and participate in that, which may be cool. But I told her I would like to come. And then there's other availability through the day. So that way I can just communicate with that person, reserve my spot. You know, learning, right? Like I didn't know. I've never had this type of access. And like I learned at MomoCon, I didn't even learn this thing even existed until MomoCon. And then out there, you had to sign in, you had to check in. But because there were more people that had already signed in, the guests were there. I'm sure there were guests, like Tanjiro, I know, never showed up. So I guess nobody was there for his. So I guess that's the way it comes. They have press availability. If people reserve the slots, they'll come do an interview with you because you got your press pass. But if there's no one there, they go about their business, which is what I would do too. So they're just going to sit there for an empty room. And if you're not there early, because you know, most people aren't just holding up their phone, they're setting up and microphone and tripod, and because it's USA Today and not Big Dub YouTube channel. So it's interesting. I'm learning. We've got Dragon Con press passes officially announced, all three of us, around our birthdays in September. And I imagine they have something similar, so we're going to have to do a lot better, a lot more diligent. I'll try to communicate better. It's just all new. It's all new for me. So I'm learning, sharing that information with you, especially for my buddies that have YouTube channels. If you get press passes, these are some questions that I don't think we ask, that they just assume you'll know, because normal people getting press passes that aren't just YouTube channels are saying, is there press availability? Is there a place I can interview people? Because they don't care about showing Marvel Legends for USA Today. They want to talk to the guests. So I'm learning. And I guess as the channel's grown, especially the last 6 months, thanks to you all, Beat Up Fit and all of that, I'm getting a little more exposure, especially locally. The local shows want me to come. So that's cool. So I learned a lot, and hopefully we'll come to another press conference in a little bit. Let me go show you some more of the show.
While I'm out here, I will show you. So they do have some gaming, Icon tournaments, Smash Brothers. You see they got it set up out here. So you can compete in tournaments in there. Oh, this is Icon tournaments. This is running the gaming. So they have their own kind of booth area out here. Bunch of plushies. And then this is where we took the picture at. This probably the thumbnail. And I like it because they've had 3 years of this con now, and it looks like they have all their guests, like Brawley. It looks like they have all their guests that they've ever had, which is really neat. So I can just keep growing it and growing it. Follow us on social media. So that's Icon Tournaments. That's who's running the gaming area. I'm going to sit down right there and play Power Rangers, Pokeballs. So certainly nowhere near the size of the gaming area that we saw at MomoCon, but still, right there. Cool to hang out. This con is super duper well organized.
The only downside, and it's more because of the hotel probably than the show, is you have to go in and out of the metal detector, which has got to be like downtown Atlanta requiring that, because I think something else we went to had a metal detector as well that slowed things down. Maybe MomoCon. No, I don't think it was in MomoCon. Is you have to go in and out of the metal detector to get to the bathroom, to get to the other areas. But it's such a big sprawling hotel. I don't know how they could control that any other way. It's the hotel's situation. But everything is very well organized. And I'm telling you, they have so many volunteers. As we were walking around last night getting autographs, each guest had a volunteer coming up. Do you need water? Do you need any food? Can I go get a coffee or whatever? And there's people just helping you as an attendee all over the place. And that's rare, because at a lot of shows, you can tell there's not enough help. Hats off to Ranger Stop for that, getting people that are involved, engaged, and supporting the show, which I like a lot. Let's go find, let's just go look at some more stuff, huh?
Yeah, see, so they would be in that press conference. You see three of the four all back at their booths, which we met those three yesterday. I don't know where Brian is. Dr. Pierre Chang from the Dharma Initiative. I was sure enough going to ask him about the Dharma Initiative, too. Mighty Gyms United. Looks like they make these, like, coasters. I don't know, like ornaments, medallions. It's probably 3D printed stuff too.
Yeah.
It's social.
Nice.
Show you that.
We love to do
so,
that.
That's a lot of cool stuff. A Ranger belt.
This takes a lot of work to do.
Yeah. Yeah, those are actual gyms. That's cool. Oh, that's neat. That's
cool. You should maybe hold them into the night.
Oh, and see the. Oh, yeah. Catches all the edges. That's beautiful. Yeah, that's pretty.
Very neat. Very neat.
Yeah, I was like, you know.
This artist, we have a ton of his art in the house. We have all those Gokus and Vegetas, except for the Ultra Ego Vegeta. That's new. I think we have the Trunks. I don't have the Golden Frieza. I don't have the Brawlies, Gogetas.
But we have like this going up. I don't know if I have the Goku Black or not. Probably. And we have the metallic ones. The All Might is cool. Thanos. CV Illustrator. And that we met him last year. Oh, that one's cool. Yeah, so that's awesome. Vegeta. The Demon Slayer ones are nice. We like him a lot. My son's sticker artwork. That's cool. Monsters here. Giving away monsters, I guess. Oh, yeah, they did, because we got one last night. Let's see. Ash Designs. I don't know if they have any social. Yeah, they do. Drip Torch Studios. They make posters. Lots of coasters. Looks like some of this might be 3D printed. Show you that screen there. Bucket hats. Ash Designs. I think they are all... I don't know. Are they also making this? No, I think this is this. But yeah, Pixel. Get stitches. Handmade bags. So we looked at this some yesterday. These are like pixelated kind of... That's like a patch. Almost like crochet. Yeah, see, like make Godzilla destroy this one last. That's cool. I like that. Exfoliate very much. Boba Fett's Mandalorian whiskey. I sure need to poop long and prosper. All this holds for if our aims keep this bathroom clean. Mine milkshake bringeth all ye gentle folk to the yard. That's fine. Doo-doo or doo-doo not, there is no try. That's nice. So I think they have all these bags. But then also this pixel art. Let's see. Yeah, here we go. Show you this. Pixels get stitches made for geeks by geeks. See about, yeah, they got a QR there. So their social medias. If you want that, you can get a little Frieza keychain. They actually have a lot of really neat stuff. Magnets. Scrunchies. A lot of stuff. You got a little gifts for the kids, ladies in your life, for yourself?
Yeah, Danny Phantom.
I mean, I have some pixelated turtles pixelated. I have Frog from Chrono Trigger. Some of the early stuff I bought at conventions is pixelated. I'm gonna see a monster gonna give me a energy drink again. Maybe they will. I hear a caw. I hear a caw. Do I hear a caw? Is that a false caw? Oh, I see Kaya. Was Kaya cawing? Was Doug caw? Let's see. I think Doug's cacawing. Were y'all cacawing or was Doug cacawing?
Yeah, Doug was cacawing.
You were doing a cacaw? Cacaw! Are you gonna get an item while you're here?
Yeah.
You gotta get something, man.
He was saying how much we look alike.
Similar, man. Oh my God. I said she got more nipples than you do.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that's, yes, she
I
needs to.
I told them about how a while ago when everybody was doing that thing of what would you look like as a man, and I did it, and it was like, oh, that's just a picture of my brother. Oh, no.
Oh, yeah.
Terrifying.
Oh.
Terrifying.
Are you gonna get this this Goku?
Probably not.
Oh, you the man. You gotta find him.
I'm looking, yeah.
You gonna get the ooh la la Chi-Chi?
No, I've already been tempted by a few. Not that one.
Which ones are you tempted by?
I'm
Is it maybe one I'm surprised by?
Yes.
Which one?
Black Rose Day.
Oh, I love that shirt. That's the first one I bought from him. Yeah.
I don't even like that character.
His shirt's awesome.
The shirt's really cool, and then I love the way the
guy's cool. So look, the next hoodie, one of the hoodies I'm going to do, that's going to be on the back. The other ones, they're going to be on the front, and I'm going to do the hood, the sleeves. It's going to have Zamasu on it and everything.
Oh, yeah, that's, yep. We're going to be having that. Yeah.
Like, it's a nice shirt.
It's the first one I ever bought from him.
No, but people love really the person. Nice.
I thought you were going to get the shirtless with the pimp chain Vegeta.
Well, Vegeta is my favorite. But, I'm still considering.
Yeah.
Good time.
Yeah.
I'm locked down.
He ain't going nowhere.
We got a few hours.
I gotta look through
the time, man.
I gotta pick up some more of that.
Hey.
Is that Dinky?
Yeah.
Sydney met Dinky. Was that exciting?
Yes, it was.
Did you give him the thumbs up?
We did a funny picture.
Oh, right. He's right there. Yeah. Who did you meet?
Kaiba.
Is that
Eric Stewart
right there?
Yeah.
White dragon.
Stop saving the world and get a hobby.
Does that please you?
Yeah. My, so apparently,
Raleigh, there's another convention.
Raleigh? North oh, yeah, Carolina. Raleigh. Yeah, I know.
So we were looking Green's at that. Going to be there,
it's,
who is Yugi. And ideally, I would get my Yugi Pop sign, and it would say, that
we
is
might
my
go
hobby.
To that, because it's loaded. It has Zach Morris from Saved by the Bell.
So it has, I don't know who that
is. It has William Shatner. You know who Zach Morris from Saved by the Bell is?
I know who William
Shatner. For shame.
I know.
For shame.
I got to get away. I got to get away. I got to get away. I'll just sit and talk all day. I gotta get away. That's cool they got those things signed. I think this is where I was at. What is that spider?
So I showed you the pixelated stuff. Rubble Base I showed you. Oh, they just straight. See, this is what I wonder why people don't know. Just straight sell snacks. Just snacks. That's the perfect reason. Go on signings with Dad. Get some Butterfingers.
Oh, look at that.
That's a humongous Hulkbuster.
Thanks, buddy.
That's cool.
Bizarre events at Hellman Elementary.
If you like to read, they are the best books around.
Best books around? A Jurassic Field Trip. What is Smoky Mountain Fam? End of July?
Yes, sir. We'll be launching book 5.
Oh, nice. Frieza. Huh. Eyeballs in a cup. Is that eyeballs in a cup?
Yes, it is. It's really good on our finger sandwich. Oh. That the lunch lady's made for us fresh.
Well, that is very special. Spider coming out. Hellman Elementary. That's cool. Very cool. Meant to check that out. Let's see. Book lockets. Coloring books. I don't see any social media for them. That's my man in your faces. You seen his booth last night. Give you a little once over the stuff at the top. Got them all out on display. So the new hoodies, he's got some new hoodies, but the brand new things are the workout shorts right there.
The leggings.
He's got tank tops and long sleeve. That's
yeah,
all
I'm
new.
I'm about to get mine.
About to get it?
Yeah.
Are you getting the Goku Rosé? Yeah.
I love the colors on that so much.
Yeah. You going to wear it to get your gym
my,
on?
That may be my first villain purchase.
Ever? Like in
like
life?
Like a villain shirt or like, I don't typically buy villain stuff.
Yeah.
I only buy hero stuff.
That's Starry Night Baby Yoda.
I've always liked
oh, hand embroidered. Whitney Stewart. Let's see. Let me put it in there. Whitney Stewart designed and sewn treasure. That's cool. A lot of stuff there.
One, two, three.
In your face! Man, let's go. Yes! On the count of three, can I get you to say squeeze it?
Yeah, let's go!
One, two, three!
Squeeze it! Will you wear it?
Your first villain?
Let's go!
You're just right going to get in the nude? I mean, we're in public. I don't know.
I'm going to go to the bathroom.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you want to wear that.
Because
that's probably a cotton. I know it's Todoroki.
This is hot.
That's cotton.
It's unpleasant.
I bet my man will have a Todoroki for all of a sudden. Because the fire and ice would make
for
some pretty wicked.
I'm going to draw him too.
So yeah. Yeah.
Cool. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
This is awesome. Thank you.
Thanks,
so
brother.
Much.
You're the man.
I'm going to go just change.
Oh.
I can't wait to see you.
Yes. Yes.
And then you got to come back and you got to do the in your face for Instagram.
There you go.
And, yeah. You got to do it.
I'll do it.
Yeah. Do it. Yeah.
Say squeeze it. What is that?
Well, you know, I mean, it's, you know, I mean, it just is. Sometimes, yeah.
I cut the camera too soon. He says something. I gotta go to the bathroom to squeeze, and we're like, yeah. And he goes, I got a bidet at home. That's a man that lives my way.
Hey, listen. My girl from India, man. So you know, she put me onto the bidet. I guess they have them all in India, and it changed my life.
I had to travel for work to Japan.
You gotta keep yourself clean, man.
I got 20 hours was the flight from Atlanta to Tokyo direct.
Yeah.
Horrible.
Yeah.
20 hours on plane.
Oh my god.
You don't. Yeah, I'm a big man. I ain't trying to use that airplane.
Yeah, man. Yeah, not me either.
I get on the got off, went immediately to the bathroom
me
in the
too.
Airport.
I don't go to the
they
bathroom
had that
airplane.
Bidet. And
change
I was like, oh, once you wash crack, you never go back.
Never go back, man. You'll be clean. You got to be, look, you got to be fresh, man. You got to be clean.
Yeah.
So, you know, a lot of times, you know, y'all get all up in there, man. That tissue don't get it all out.
That's what's right.
You got to clean yourself, man. So you need to blast it within there, you know, blast and get it clean, man. You know
lessons from in your face. Because if you're going to be in your face, you better be fresh.
You better be fresh.
Otherwise, you're going to be at a distance, not quite in the face.
Yeah, man. When you're dealing with a lot of people, you got to be on point, man.
So, can't be stank.
Clean your ass, okay? Just wash your ass.
It's the greatest segment in Double Life history right there.
All right, so these are the two that I think. Kaya, do you want to go with me and we'll try to go to a press conference to meet the Pokemon? Are you going to ask him a question or are you scared? You can give me the questions and I'll ask it for you. Sailor Pluto. It's all these people. What do you know from all the things they're in? Do you know things that they do?
Pokemon.
Gotta speak up. We're in a crowd. They can't hear you.
Ash from Pokemon.
Yep.
Brock.
Squirtle.
Squirtle. Brock and James from Pokemon. And the other guy from Yu-Gi-Oh.
Yeah. Do you want to go with me to that in a few minutes? Are you nervous? You went up in front of all them people, told them about your cosplay idea. Or your contest of champions.
Yes.
Maybe. Contemplating it? She's nervous. So now we get over here. We got the guests from all of that. I didn't even know they were here. Did you watch all of that?
Yes.
I thought so. I remember. So, more guests. The whole room is surrounded by guests, which is cool. I do not think I saw this yesterday. I'm going to catch this in case I forget because it's on the end. Acrylic charms. That's cool.
She's got great stuff, man.
It looks awesome. Hey, how are you?
Sleepy.
We kept her sleepy. Yeah, I feel it.
Melatonin gummies are still in my system a little bit.
Ah.
So I'm kind of like waking up.
Still not quite ready. So you can get the. No, you're fine. So these are all the My Hero pillows. These little dice bags. Well, I wonder if Kaya has seen this booth. This looks like a Kaya booth. Looks like Kaya booth. So they're not neon lights cast. That's a cool booth.
I was here yesterday, but when you built here, it's someone else's booth.
Ah.
I'm the only one in this room.
Hey, that's great. Let me find my daughter. I think she'll like your booth. Let me find her. Ka-ka! I've lost Kaya. Now, I don't know if I went down this at all yesterday. I know I'm saying that to you like you know. Oh, that's a tattoo. So you can get tattoos right here, which is a thing I'm starting to see in all the cons we go to. Which is cool, like if that's what you're into. Cosplay gloves. Looks like Ranger gloves. Long and short. Oh, that's cool. Hello, how are you?
Very good, how are you?
I'm great, thank you.
Enjoying yourself today?
Yes, very much, very much. How are you doing? Good show? Yes. Oh, those are nice. It's good Ranger guests. You're going to need cosplay gloves. Got some artists here. Let's see who this is. There you go. Freestylecomics.com with a K. I'm trying to show you these artists here. Scorpio. Oh, these are creators, actually. Yeah, these are like comic creators. Scorpio Comics. Dark Fantasy Horror. They're beautiful with the gold. K2O Customs. So these are like custom patches.
We'll make them out.
I also have a Forever.
It's a Ranger
Forever
stuff.
Red Mystery Box.
Oh, okay. Patch
you
Mystery
know
Box.
Get.
Shannon Menner art. There's one illustrator. Looks like they're doing commissions. And then Hero Booster.
Hello.
Hello, how are you?
Great, how are you?
I am wonderful, thank you. That's cute.
Everything here was drawn by Mark.
Yes.
Everything here was written by me.
Awesome.
And we made this together.
Oh, that's very cool.
Feel free to pick it up, take a look
yeah,
inside.
Show through it. I like that. Art style. Sound like a cacao. Is that for me? That's cool. Garlic Champions. 30 seconds or less, a novella of Victor Santiago.
That is a book about time traveling pizza.
That's cool. Let me find out if that was my family cacaoing for me. Victoria!
Wait,
did you cacao? Cacao! Did you cacao for me?
We were looking for you, yes.
Jason David Frank,
no,
looks
I was...
like John Cena. That's not him?
No, he's not out there yet.
That guy looks like John Cena a little bit. You were looking for me?
You were cacaoing for me?
Boyfriend, yes.
Yes? Oh, you found snacks?
Did you hear the cacao?
I did.
So it'll be.
It's there. On camera while I was talking to this artist
oh,
over
yay.
Here. Kaya, that gentleman has a book about time traveling pizza. And there's a booth I think you will like on the other side of this curtain that is
I don't really know how to describe it, but it's a booth Kai will like. Nice. What were y'all calling for? Just searching for me?
They were just trying to see where you were.
I'm here.
She had gotten her snacks.
So this is the line for Jason David Frank. Are you sure that's not Jason? That's not Jason David Frank. Looks like John Cena.
No, that's not
he's wearing a Hawkins High School shirt, I think.
I mean, it looks like John Cena's off the juice.
I was going to walk by to look at my childhood crush, but then I was like, no, it's not those people.
So this is all the Rangers. I'll go down the outside because this is only going to get more and more busy.
Especially.
So Jason David Frank isn't here yet. Karen Ash, she's one of the ones that runs the show, I think. We'll come back to these inside ones in a minute. Nakia also, I believe, is one of the ones that runs the show. Well, they have a Rangers endgame. If you're a Rangers fan, you could have met all of them except the Red Ranger in the last 2 weeks. Red Ranger's in a little bit of trouble. I think he's going to jail. Blake Fogg, oh, he's got a wrestling belt. Rumble of the Rangers, Blake Foster. Vulcan Skull, Selwyn Ward. So you see, and then these are all Rangers guests all the way down until you get to the Turtles guests back down there. So half of it, obviously, at Ranger Stop. I think there's like 13 or 14 of the different Rangers, Space Rangers, Psycho Rangers that you can meet, which is wonderful.
All right, let me get back inside where I was at and show you some more stuff.
Crafty A's cat. Hand stuff. I wonder if they have a... Yeah, here we go. I'm trying to show you the information in case you're interested, because I know a lot of folks can't go to the shows, but a lot of these places have Etsy stores and so forth, and you're able to buy the same stuff online, especially since the pandemic. A lot of folks have opened up websites, Etsy stores, so
any of these things, Sailor Moon, something
that you might be interested in, you can do. Custom commission art here. He's drawing stuff right on the table. That's cool. Is this a cosplay? That's cool. I think this cosplayers. Yeah, cosplayer way stuff. That's cool. I know Damien may know. There's a lot of those folks.
Aang is cool.
Is that like graffiti? I don't even know how to.
That's neat.
Demon Slayer. It's like splatter.
It's very cool. You made this too. How you doing? I'm sorry. I'm in your way.
Yeah, I like that. You see that? That Miles is beautiful with the Jays. Storm. That's very cool. Hello, how are you?
I'm great.
Oh, the guard slam.
That's neat.
Illustrations.
You can take one if you want.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you. I like that darn salmon. That's neat. Very neat. Oh, you get all five Ranger prints, $25. And go get them signed. Cosplay. Oh, Riddler. All right, that's where we're at. Gloves. We saw these guys at MetrophonCon. So they have a lot of pops you can get signed while you're here. Oh, you can get a Squirtle Pop signed. They have the exclusive suit. So I actually thought about, I have some of these that are loose, where it's the turtle holding the Ranger helmet. I thought that'd be like, if there's a one that has Leonardo and the White Ranger, I could get that double signed here. But there is not. So, they do it for My Hero. None of this. We don't buy them already signed because we want to have the experience of meeting them. It's part of what you're paying for. And honestly, you get it less. But just in case they happen to have the pop I'm looking for, but I don't think they do. Those are cheap. Those are cheap. Sailor Mars. And then, if I remember right, this is the booth. Yeah, they have this. These that have the drawing on the side, and I think they're also signed. Yeah, so it's the art, black light hit. Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah, those are beautiful. I think the first time I saw pops like that were in Nashville with the Jim Henson guy, the Muppet guy. So these are the graded ones. So that one, graded.
with the art and the signature. Signed by Chris Sabat. That's a very, very cool thing. Masqueraded.
We're doing good, you.
Raleigh. Playing crazy. They also, you can drop off for CBCS. You get signature authentication.
Yep, you do.
Very cool. Very cool. So we bought, I showed you this yesterday. You can find them on Instagram just like that. We bought that kind of glass print one. He's got a bunch of stuff. We bought stuff from him last night, some bookmarks. He's the one that has these lenticulars. Let's see if I can show you the change for me. So you got Deku, Todoroki, Bakugo. We like lenticular art like that. A little kind of arts and crafts, bows. There we go. Let me zoom in on that for you. Kitches and Crossbones. Looks like an Instagram tag. Lots of handmade stuff, bows. Also stuff for the girls here, which makes me happy. Because I go to so many things where it's just Marvel Legends stuff for me. Oh, I like that. Good, how are you doing, man? Excellent. Yeah, I'm doing the coverage for the con. Yeah. Dewey the Artist. Contact him there. That Ultra Instinct, Ultra Ego, that's nice there. I like that. Buy that, get it signed. I guess that's why you got it front and center. Get it signed right away, same day. Yeah. Moonlight. Commissions, I think it's only lost 10 bucks. Very nice. You'll find a munchkin.
All done by hand, too.
All done by hand. Commissions you're doing right here.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you got, yeah. Nice. He's only charging $10 for like a, like just an ink of a sketch. I want to find Kaya and see if she wants to commission something from him. I'm trying to find her. You broke down, you had to do it. You had to do it.
Because I have a Vegeta, thanks to you.
She gave you a mwah. You got to get a mwah. She's wonderful, isn't she?
She is. She's very sweet. She's so many good characters.
Yes.
Full Metal Alchemist, My Hero, Dragon Ball. There's another one that I really like, too.
She's floppy.
I'm so shocked that she was into Gray Man. I love that anime, and every time I talk to people about it, they're like, what's the Gray Man? I'm like, what?
She's floppy.
Yeah, that was My Hero, yeah.
Is she Hello Kitty?
Yeah.
I appear so.
Oh, Assassination Classroom is very good.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Oh, I've just bumped into the water with my hind end. I have a wet booty. Wet booty. James just wandering about. So we're going to go. Do you have a question of mine you want to ask?
No.
I mean, we may be the only ones in there.
No.
Maybe Kaya's press conference.
I don't know. It's into it. Or Brian's. It can be picked out. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, if it's just us, we'll ask him. We'll ask him if... be Kai's first press conference. It could be Big Dubs, but we're going to find out. We're going to find out. Are you nervous, aren't you? A little bit. Well, we'll see. If we're the only ones in here, are you going to just handle the press conference yourself? Kimiko?
Kimiko.
Kimiko said that that's allowed. You can do it.
That's my gamer tag.
Yeah. Well, on everything? Steam? Xbox? Kimiko?
Kimiko TV.
What games do you play?
I mainly play, I used to be like an MMORPG person.
Yeah.
So World of Warcraft was my thing. Yeah. But now I play a lot of first person shooters and battle royales.
You playing Halo? New Halo?
Not anymore.
Fortnite?
Yeah, Overwatch? Sometimes. I do like Overwatch.
What's the one with A? Anthem?
Apex Legends.
Apex Legends. Oh, that was the one.
Yeah.
That was the one. All right. We've got our friends here. Kaya, what would you like to ask them? It's the Kaya press conference.
Yeah, so nice. Thank you for joining us at our press conference.
Yes.
How long ago did you start voice acting, and like, how did you kind of get into it? Do you want to start?
No.
Okay. I'll start. I started acting when I was 5. I did all the plays in my elementary school, my high school. I have a bachelor's in acting from college, and I have a master's in acting from graduate school. I toured the United States with several acting companies with Shakespeare and contemporary and children's theater. I just happened to get an audition for an anime through an acting coach of mine. And because of that, I was cast in that, and then they said, can you audition for this? And then things kind of went on from there. So ultimately, the short answer is training and luck.
I started as a musician, and I got an offer to work in a recording studio in New York City. And I thought that they would be focusing on music. Turned out that they focused on casting and producing radio and TV commercials, mostly voiceovers. And so I learned all about the business, from making coffee and getting scripts ready for clients, to then working my way up to being a casting director, and then finally being a producer and running the studio. I stumbled into it. I loved comedy. I was definitely a class clown in school and got in a lot of trouble for it, which is nice that I make a living doing that now. I learned a lot from especially the woman that I worked for, Alice Whitfield. She's a genius when it comes to voice acting and coaching. And I absorbed also, like a sponge, when I would give direction in casting sessions, the feedback from those actors, how they interpreted the scripts, and just was paying attention to that. And then when I finally decided to go on the road as a musician, I contemplated what job I could have that would allow me to work from anywhere, and that would support my love of playing original music, and voice acting made the most sense. I also do a lot of the production side. I'm a director and an engineer and a producer of a lot of the shows that you've watched. So, jack of all trades that way. So yeah, I stumbled into it, and now it's funny, I can't imagine what else I would do for a living. I've been doing it for close to 35 years now.
Wow.
Yeah. When both of you kind of started voice acting, because you both seemed to kind of like stumble upon it, not really looking to, but you kind of ended up in it. When you first got cast for the role you had in Pokemon, how was your reaction to that? And like starting and voice acting anime?
Yeah, I think we were both working on Slayers actually before the auditions for Pokemon. Mm-hmm. So we had been working together on other things. I think I didn't really know that much about Pokemon before we auditioned for it. So I loved what it looked like. I loved the roles that I was auditioning for and really hoped that I was able to get a part in it. But even though they said, oh, it's going to go on TV, I really didn't believe that would be true.
Right.
So it was hard to get excited before. It wasn't one of those like, yes, type things like Ninja Turtles.
Sure.
We'd all heard of that before, so that was pretty exciting to be cast in it.
Yeah.
But I don't know. Did you know more about it?
So I was brought in probably 6 months before to do a promo for an up-and-coming show called Pokemon. And all I had to say was like, coming soon, Pokemon. And it was I think there were about 5 or 6 people in the room. No one knew exactly how to pronounce the word. And I wasn't told what it was. And I just did these promos for it. And I thought, that's kind of interesting. And then I was brought in to audition for the show. I actually didn't get any roles in the very beginning, which is kind of funny. I replaced the other Brock, who never actually dubbed the show. They decided to go with their second choice, which was kind of a backhanded compliment, but I'll take it.
Total compliment.
Right?
Total compliment.
And then James, I replaced a dear friend of mine who did I think the first 5 or 8 episodes, but he's a stage actor. He wanted to pursue that. And so at first it was a voice match, and then I took on the craziness of James' laugh and the broad stuff that he does. But every time we are asked to audition for anything, we're always told, this is going to be huge, this is going to be great, it's going to be amazing. And as actors, we also know to say, yeah, we hear that a lot. I can't tell you the amount of shows that I've actually been in that have gone nowhere, right? So you don't go in thinking this is going to be a big deal. As the ripples of the promotion started to go on, once we started working on it, it was like, this seems to be kind of popular. I think it was the day that there was like Pokemon cereal in the grocery store that it was like, oh, okay, this is interesting. But yeah, I mean, it's very humbling to be part of such a big part of pop culture history. If you're 6 or 60, you know what you've heard of Pokemon. So that's kind of neat. But yeah, it wasn't like, yeah, I got cast in this huge show, because it wasn't. at that point.
No. I remember seeing the big, what is it, in Times Square, like the marquee,
right.
The big, whatever, for Pokemon, the first movie.
Right.
And I remember standing under that with my family and getting a photo, like, oh my God, we're here, we're in Times Square.
Yeah.
Really amazing.
Well, we got to go to a red carpet event of that screening at the Ziegfeld.
And, in New York, yeah.
Which is was a very famous theater. And, you know, that was not on my list of what I thought I was going to be doing.
Yeah.
You know,
incredible.
With my life. Yeah. Bonus.
When you both were told to like voice act different Pokemon, what was your reaction to that? Knowing you just really had to make noises and say your names, were you able to use your voices to make them really come to life?
Yeah, it was fun because you know, most of the time we were brought in to do our human characters, right? And if a Pokemon made its first appearance in an episode, usually the director would look or listen to the original Japanese for a reference, right? To hear what the vocal sound was and say, oh, well, Eric is coming in today and that he probably could do something that sounds like that. So let's just assign. I never auditioned for a Pokemon. It was more like, you're gonna be doing this one. And one of the reasons why at least with the earlier Pokemon, they don't bark or chirp, they say parts of their name, was to educate those watching what their names were. So if you're saying Squirtle, Squirt, Squirt, Squirtle, you're probably gonna say, oh yeah, that's Squirtle, right? and that was part of it. So I loved doing all of that stuff because you're also challenged to interpret a statement or script without real words. You know, I could give you an entire monologue by saying squirt, squirt, squirtle, and you probably would understand what kind of I was talking about, whether I was in danger, whether I'm having fun. You would get the energy behind it. And that, as an actor, that's a great challenge to be able to do that.
It's a lot of improv in a sense too. And I think none of us questioned anything because we wanted to keep our jobs. Mm-hmm. And so you just say, I can do it. And then you figure out while you're in the middle of it, how to make sense of it all. So I agree, great challenge.
And the water gun attack was totally me. It wasn't a sound effect. That's me doing that.
This is probably a bit of a standard question, but what are your guys' favorite Pokemon?
Mine's Pikachu, for sure.
Squirtle.
Yeah.
For you, when you were brought in to voice act as a male character, was that something that you were kind of curious about, or had it like happened before?
Yeah, I played Jim Hawkins on stage actually, and the audience bought that I was a boy for that, and that was only a couple years before I started doing Ash. So I didn't really think about that. As an actor, you just play everything. I never questioned it. I just did my best. They wanted us to match the original Japanese actors in our auditions, so I was able to do that and combine it with something that I thought was kind of boyish. And I think also we would say in the first season, all of the voices kind of evolved mm-hmm. into what they would eventually be as they were figuring out what it would be.
Yeah. And you know, one of the reasons why young boy roles usually played by women is because their voices don't change, right? So you know, if you cast a 10-year-old boy to play a 10-year-old boy, when that 10-year-old actor becomes a 30-year-old actor, he's probably not going to sound like a 10-year-old boy anymore.
But I still did.
Yeah, and it's I think it's a great voice for that character.
It's so fun.
Yeah, I mean, it's
fun
perfect.
To do.
It's perfect.
Yeah. Yeah, I did a lot of my gurgling sounds myself too,
like
underwater and stuff. I think the show was really fun. We had so much action in mm-hmm. it that we were able to bring a lot to any of the roles we played that we didn't have the opportunity in other cartoons to do.
Sure, that's the freedom of voice acting, is that we can play anything we can sound like.
Yeah.
I'm surprised you played a male on stage, and I'm impressed that went over so well. In our voice world, we can play anything.
Yeah.
You know, age-wise, that's what sex you are, stuff like that. Anything you can sound like, which is like, you know, theater of the mind. You could just be anything.
Yeah.
That's really neat.
Yeah. Plus, Treasure Island is a pretty awesome place.
There you
playing
go.
Jim Hawkins.
There,
For a lot of people, they got into either whether it be cartoons or anime, just that general drawn animation category by watching Pokemon growing up or a little later on in their lives. So, and usually they do it in the English voices because that's what mainly is broadcast, whether it be on TV or streaming services. So how does it feel to know that you, your voices, were some of the first things that inspired or influenced others to get into those kinds of...
Right, you're probably too young to remember like that, you know, Blockbuster video stores where the anime was in the back corner with like on a, on like three shelves, right? If you wanted to find anime, it's like it was...
You had to really
Right? And I really, and I say this as being part of the show, but also, you know, I was not the main force behind Pokemon, but Pokemon changed that. Pokemon made anime mainstream Saturday morning cartoons, right? It was accessible now. Every country thinks that Pokemon is theirs, right? France watched it, Germany watched it. They watched that dub. They didn't think of it as a Japanese anime dub. Most kids don't, didn't. And it changed where anime was. It was no longer in the back corner of Blockbuster, and Blockbuster goes out of business, whatever. It was everywhere. I just think that it's interesting the way we made that a sort of a general show and not specifically for this one genre was kind of a neat experiment. And it really, I think that it made a big difference. I think Pokemon made a big difference to that.
It's really an honor to be part of something that hit people so deeply. You know, and I think when you watch it when you were 10 and when you watch it when you're 30, you realize how much you've learned from the show. I know I have, as a person and as an actor. I realize as the years go by how much more I learned when I was working on the show. And it's really cool to be part of something like that. Mm-hmm. There's certainly things that I watched when I was little that influenced where I am now. And it's really neat to be part of something that has influenced people, but then have the opportunity to come to a convention and talk to people about
that.
That's the other thing, that we get to hear stories about people growing up, finding their best friends, all of that, making their career choices, like you say, becoming an artist or a writer or an actor, and it's really amazing.
Yep.
I don't have the words to fully express how incredible that is.
We had great, you know, in the early days, we had some of the best writers working on that show. I mean, and also, it's not rocket science why that show is successful, all right? There is something redeemable about every character. You can connect to someone, whether you like the good guy, the goofy bad guys, whatever, but the underlying thing is there's always a moral to those without being preachy.
Yeah, exactly.
And that makes a difference. Even when people are, oh, you know, it's too wholesome, it's too this, it's like, yeah, but see, that registers with people because it's a good message. And when cartoons don't have that, they might have better sound effects and louder music and more action. They don't have the longevity of a show like Pokemon because they don't have the core moral that is always there.
Right.
Whether it's the bond of friendship or whether it's, you know, learning a lesson about not doing something wrong and forgiveness or whatever it may be. That's always been in there. And I think that's what made that show last so long.
I think, too, what I learned somewhat recently, Satoshi Tajiri, he really loved bugs and he loved nature. And that's why he created this show. And there's something so elemental about it, so natural and so natureful, that I think we can all identify with it wherever we live, whatever language we speak, it speaks to us. So it is pretty amazing.
Yeah. All right, we're walking out. We're gonna come out here where there's no music, can't get copyrighted, so Kai can talk to you. So that was Veronica Taylor and Eric Stewart. So Veronica Taylor, voice of Sailor Pluto, and the voice of who? Ash
Ketchum.
And then Pokemon. Eric Stewart, voice of who?
Brock and
some from Yu-Gi-Oh,
James,
right?
From Pokemon, and the main like antagonist from Yu-Gi-Oh.
And Squirtle. So that truly was a private press conference between Kaya and the Pokemon guest.
Yep.
She's the only one that asked questions. You saw all 15 minutes, the entire, we had the whole thing just for us. How does that make you feel? She is wonderful. So one of the things that we try to work with her on is not saying ums or things like that, to speak clearly, not use slang. I thought she did wonderful. I don't think you said a single time. You paused when you were uncertain of what to say, gathered yourself, spoke. It was amazing. You did amazing. Didn't you do wonderful? Was it fun?
Yes.
So a year ago, you didn't even think you'd ever go to a convention.
No.
Now you're conducting a press conference by yourself. Yeah. Don't you think she should take over this channel one day? That video I'm probably going to put also separately. So you're watching on a Dub Life right now. But it was long enough that I think I can just stick it up on the channel as its own press conference for people that want to talk to those guests. And you can see Kai do it. So if you're watching Dub Life but you haven't watched that, go watch that video to support that kiddo. Even if you see it here, just go watch it, leave a comment and a like or whatever. So that get out, and that way I can tag those guests in it. They can promote it and so forth. Oh, hey. So one moment. So tell me your thoughts about doing that. You weren't sure you wanted to do it.
See, here's how my brain usually does things.
Also, look at the kick. She's got the cause, collab. We've got the Zoom comforts. This is how your brain processes favorites. Things.
I'm really, nervous and brain mush before, but when I start doing it, it's, perfect.
So you're a game time player. You know what that means? So some people get really nervous and anxiety, oh, my goodness, there's a game. You know, if you're a basketball player, say. It's a game. Oh, you're really nervous. You're shaking. But as soon as the ball is tipped and the lights go on, it's going in. You're making it. And as soon as the game's over, you're nervous again. But when the lights are on, you're a game player.
Whenever it's actually happening, my brain works. But all the other time, it doesn't.
So I think you did wonderful. That has to be. I mean, I'm trying to think. Of all the people that are going to watch this video, including all our friends, I don't believe any of them have probably had that at a convention. Now, certainly some of them have done meet and greets and interviews with people. You had a private press conference with two major guests.
That was very cool.
So we want to say thank you to Ranger Stop and Pop for letting us do that. Kimiko for giving us basically private access. And, of course, to the Pokemon guests. They were wonderful, Veronica and Eric. Nice. I told them ahead of time it's just going to be her asking questions. They're like, that's great. Let's do it. And I thought they may only answer one question, but 15 minutes. And they took pictures with us. I'll put the pictures here. Kai, do you think we look good in those pictures? Do you think we look like Pokemon?
I haven't seen the pictures.
So right now I'm showing the people. Tell us if we look like Pokemon. We should probably go find Mom, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think so. Are you going to go tell Mom all about it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What is happening here? Hey, get it, Victoria. Victoria is doing the Macarena with a Power Ranger. Hey! And shake it!
Give us a rub.
Oh! Rub it!
Squeeze it! Subscribe to the boys. What? Give it a little plug. Give it a little plug.
Jordan Gasly on YouTube. How's it going, everybody?
We're in a whole lot of the same shows.
We are.
Having a good time.
We're just big dubbing it over here.
Hey, you know, Kai, what are you doing? You're like, can we please stop talking and go inside and look at action figures? Well, not action figures. Keychains?
No.
You want to go get some art commission? That's what we need to do. I need to go back to that guy I said I'd be right back to an hour ago, and that's not good.
But listen, time is all relative, right? It's a man-made construct. Right back could be 2 days from now.
That's true. It could be next year.
It could be.
Yeah. Well, this is the right back that I'm in.
Yeah.
That's true.
Hey, for all that guy knows, you could be a time traveler. It was 3 minutes for you, but it was a week for him.
I am actually a time traveler. That's true.
But you are?
Yeah. She loves time travel. We've returned. Commissions, inks only, $10, waist up, $20. Do you want a bust or do you want waist up?
Bust.
Bust is like shoulders versus waist, yeah.
Yeah.
You want to get one?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Do you know what you want? Are you going to tell my friend what you want? Can she get a commission? All right. Well, what are you going to tell him? What do you want? Oh, you don't know yet. One moment. So she really likes his Moon Knight style. Let me show you again. Do the artist. In fact, we'll keep this. Put that in your bag. So she's going to get a bust of Moon Knight. We'll get that in a little while. Shout out to my man Dewey. Taking care of the kiddo. We're trying to support artists. All right. Hello, hello.
How are you?
Wonderful. How are you?
Good.
So we got scrolls. That's what we love to do.
Look at that tiger.
Those are cool.
Is this their business card?
Yeah.
So I have large and small scrolls. I have small ones with the tiger.
Yeah.
Small ones with the hunches. And then I do small ones with the frog as well.
Oh, that's cool.
Huntress.
Sure.
Very cool.
Which are technically saving money if you buy them, because you don't have to buy a frame.
That is true. You spend more money on frames than the art sometimes, it feels like.
That is true.
Did you say you're going to put the scroll on your bathroom door and you pull it down when you're busy?
One of my doors. I got doors.
All right, so there's this art. I don't think I've shown you this. Kaya did by that wall scroll, which is cool. It's a kind of pixelated art, too. There's Rita, Sonic, Leonardo. Leonardo leads. I wonder if they have all of them. Donatello does machines. I wonder if they have all the turtles from the theme song. That would be cool. Because Raphael is cool but rude. He's also the best turtle. Castlevania, Nintendo Switch. This has pillows. I think we saw this last week, too. With the Sailor Moon pillow. I feel like I saw it. This booth has Pops. Megazord, no worries. The nun demonic, oh boy. And I think that probably gives you an overview of everything. Over here, a couple more artists, authors. So that's a script, it looks like. A little bit of everything. All right. So I think that gives you an overview, a broad overview of the show in general. I think I've shown every booth. I've tried to tag as many things as I could. Now I'm just going to walk around, enjoy the con, get up to no good, find everybody else, and hang out. So I don't know what else you're about to see on Dub Life. You've probably seen a lot of this show, press conference, all that stuff. But now it's just time to Dub Life it. You know what I mean?
Yep.
There's Jason David Frank. He is here now. At least I show him. I don't think Victoria's waiting in that line, but now.
Oh, we got wrestling.
We got Ric Flair. I don't even know what's happening.
A wolf pack with the Black Ranger.
What's up?
Hey.
We're about to get some art.
I like their art. Oh, yeah, this is where we got it before.
Yeah.
So Kaya herself conducted a 15-minute private interview with both of them.
Wow. How was that?
It was the Kaya interview, literally. It was. We were the only ones at the press conference. She asked all the questions. 15 minutes.
Wow, that's awesome.
Yeah.
She did great. Is that going to be in your video?
Absolutely.
All right.
Yeah.
I'm going to watch that.
You going to watch it?
Hey, did your mom say I had a favor to ask of you?
Oh, a favor?
I haven't seen my mom.
So, I'm going to the Pokemon North America International Championships at the end of this month.
He needs to borrow all your cards.
I need to borrow a couple cards.
Yeah, okay.
I was going to swing by at some point over the next week or so.
Yeah, of course.
Because my deck, I don't collect it physically very much anymore. And my deck, if I just bought it all, is like $220. But like five of those, 150 of it, is just like five very expensive cards.
You need some energy, right?
Yeah. Or RCSVs.
Oh, yeah. I have a bunch of energy.
We have a lot of them. Just look for
the Midas. We got you.
All right.
I appreciate it. If you guys aren't busy, like, tomorrow or next weekend, I'll stop by.
Make it happen.
Of course, yeah.
Thank you, guys.
No problem.
Were y'all in the nude?
No, literally. You texted me at 12:58 and 12:59. I responded at 12:59. And same with me. You texted at 12:55 and I responded at 1. Well, I was a little closer.
That's about par for the course for you.
Do you believe?
I responded within
urgent need 2 hours later. Yes?
Would you believe that somebody may have engaged in a Macarena?
Oh, they all have seen it.
Yeah. I did send Brian the video.
Yeah. Would you believe that Kaya conducted a 15-minute private press conference with the two Pokemon?
What question?
Well, you have to watch this episode of Double to find out. Is it true that the reason you were dancing like that is because Jason David Frank came in and you said, hey, big boy, let me do a little sachet?
Yes.
Back at this booth, I didn't realize they had like these kind of stained glass.
They're actually 3D wood.
Oh, that must be one of the ones Victoria said she wanted a bunch of things. It's that one, isn't it? That one down the bottom, underneath the Hogwarts
Give
store.
Me some Sopranos.
Yes.
I like that one. Sopranos and The Godfather. Look at the detail on these. Very cool. Very, very cool. Beautiful pieces of art.
Now we got Jordan 1s on too.
We're all wearing our shirts that Doug gave us. Tori's got her new shirt on.
Yes.
Victoria made the appropriate shoe selection. My feet are on fire.
My feet are comfortable.
Yay.
And also kind of on fire, honestly.
Are you going to get this
one? They hurt a little bit.
Is that the one you want?
One of my favorite Harry Potter quotes ever.
Yeah, it's very cool.
And it's a good life quote.
It is. Happiness is the darkest time. I'll ever turn on the light.
Yep, just have to find out what your light is.
Rufus is a light.
Yeah. He makes me so happy.
James and Sydney had to go, so it was good to see James, hang out with him for several hours. Hung out with him a ton recently. What?
Hold on. Oh, Dalek!
Come on, I'm your father. Beep!
Dalek and RT!
That is funny.
I agree, that is funny. So we're going to figure out what we're going to purchase. I think we're going to get some of this wood art. We have to pick up Kai's commission. I'll show you that. And then we're probably going to get out of here, go home, get the puppy out. We're going to see Jurassic World later tonight, so we'll talk about that as we get closer. But again, good to see James, Sydney. Thanks for hanging out, guys. And probably next stop is the commission.
So you got Zelda.
Oh, cool. I love it. I like it on the wood. I think it looks really good.
And Victoria then I finally got... picked something, too. Oh, I didn't even see they had
me
that.
Neither.
And you got something for your mom?
Yes. That's and then cool. I got something for my mom.
What did you get? Did you get that one that I like skin
I got...
people?
That's a baby? No. Give me skin or something.
Skin suit?
No, I got to hear
you. Got that one. Yes, yes, yes. No skin suit. Yeah. Alas.
Alas.
Y'all want to eat the varsity? What do you have? What do you have?
Oh,
that'll be diarrhea.
He's ready to show you your commission. Are you going to come get it? Are you walking sheepishly?
Yeah,
let's show it again. Dewey the artist, contact him. Contact him. Oh, there's one already in there, but I show her how to contact him.
Awesome.
Very
Thank you
good.
So much.
No problem. That looks great.
Is it Sailor Moon Knight? Oh, it's just regular Moon Knight.
So we were watching Batman vs. Superman. And so Henry Cavill, you know, pretty beefy, right? And he looks beefy in that suit. She's like, is that all just CG? And then there's a shirt where he's shirtless. She's like, oh, no. No, that man just big.
Look, he's thick too.
Look at that, he's got riblets. He got ab in his ribs. That's not for big guys. Big guys don't get that. Huh? Yeah. I eat riblets. I can do that.
Well, that looks wonderful. Thank you, man. I appreciate you guys. That looks great. That is great.
Check out the man, Dewey the artist. D-E-W-I-E, the artist. $20 for that commission. Yeah, only $20. $10 if it had just been like shoulders up. So up-and-coming artists getting started. We like to support that. So thanks to my man. We're probably about to wrap up here. I'm going to walk back over here by Jason David Frank one more time.
Look, Victoria's meeting Jason David Frank. Well, and a Red Ranger that's just kind of... now it's just Red Ranger's butt cheeks.
Oh.
Oh, there
oh,
he is.
Oh.
Say hey, Jason.
Hey.
You go.
I just realized when I was doing the Macarena, I was genuinely doing it in front of the All That cast.
Yes.
Like directly.
You go.
I don't know this one.
Oh. Doug, you go. You go.
Huh?
You go.
Not to that song.
Oh.
I would have did it to the Soulja Boy joint, but, you know, I was too busy, man.
Before we leave, that's the Jason David Frank line. It goes in that corner, and it goes as far as you can see. Way out of this.
He
maybe
must have
even
been
downstairs.
More than just my travel
impression. Oh. Well, I mean, probably this gentleman as well, yes?
Yeah.
We're down two floors. That's still that line. Woo, people will be waiting. He did say, Jason David Frank did say, he will stay here until every single person gets their autograph, however long it takes. He's only here today, has some other conflicts, but good on him to meet all these people.
Did you just ask to say Tahoe?
Hole.
Huh. Well, maybe. I mean, you never know. Maybe Tahoe. He may think so. Did we enjoy ourselves at the show?
Very much.
Yeah? So, there's like 3 hours left today. We're going to leave early because go... spend some time with the puppy before we go see the movie, eat some lunch, all that jazz. What was your favorite part of the show, Kai?
I really like the interview.
Like interviewing the guests. Yesterday she just said, oh, Ranger, stop. So we now have a clear-cut favorite.
Yes.
Natalie, what was your favorite part of the last 2 days? Meeting Sailor Pluto?
Yeah.
She got to interview Sailor Pluto. She didn't ask a Sailor question, though. But it was Sailor Pluto, press conference. What was your favorite part?
Pokemon characters, though, right?
But she's also, she's Ash.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was just those two guests. I mean, you could have asked them, like, what do you like for supper? Kaya asked great questions, though. I was going to ask, what do you like for supper? And, any recommendations. What was your favorite part, Victoria? Doing the Macarena in front of Jason David Frank?
It was, I guess he was there too.
Yeah,
doing the Macarena in front of all that cast with a Power Ranger and a lion.
What a peculiar statement. Well, that's wonderful.
So again, thanks to Ranger Stop and Pop here in Atlanta having us out. They have the show coming up in Orlando that's tempting later, about 6 months from now. But they had us out, gave us a lot of good access. Wonderful. We loved the show last year, loved it again this year. A lot of cool experiences. It's a very familial, we're going that way, atmosphere. Everybody feels like family, very kind, a lot of kindness. And we love it. So thanks to Ranger Stop.
Chick-fil-A in it.
We just filmed the Friday hunt video that you would have watched on Friday with very little success. But we did get some of the frames we needed.
We did.
Low battery mode. So we're picking up Chick-fil-A. We're going to go home, spend a couple hours with the puppy. Then it's time for Jurassic World.
Ooh.
So I think the next clip will be... Well, there may be something I show you at home, but... Do you think seductive Ian Malcolm is going to come into play? Shirtless?
Probably
wounded?
Not.
I'm not sure. You know what I'm talking about? Seductive Ian Malcolm from Jurassic Park, where he's hurt and his shirt is ripped open and he's laying there with his hip up.
I don't remember that.
One moment. I don't know why I said one moment. Put it in your search history. Google seductive Ian Malcolm.
Gosh,
seductive.
All right,
Ian
I will do
Malcolm.
That. So seductive Ian Malcolm.
Did it suggest it?
No.
Oh.
No, it's not.
It's there. Yeah, it looks.
Oh, goodness.
Yeah, seductive Ian Malcolm, where he's hurt. Just pop that mother picture
like
big.
There's figures of it and stuff.
Yeah, it's actually, I think, Mattel's SDCC. They have, like, the book that Ian Malcolm wrote as, like, the chaos theory. And you open it up, and it's seductive Ian Malcolm
in
the middle.
Oh, I prefer the older version.
Oh.
He recreated it.
You trying to holler?
He got the gray going.
Oh, yeah. Oh. So are you hoping that's in the movie? Because that would be the modern gray version. Then they pay homage. You don't have nostalgia for seductive Ian Malcolm?
No, I don't really recall that part.
All right, we're
is that
gonna...
a pop?
Yeah, there's probably that. I think James wanted that pop as a con exclusive a few years ago. Chicken nuggets.
Yeah, it's pop right there.
So we got these things framed up. We have something else I want to show you. But I do have prizes for everybody. Here's Natalie's prize. Rufus, do you want Natalie's prize? She doesn't want it.
I got waffle fry in mouth.
Waffle fry in mouth.
Oh, I love that.
Oh, Rufus does want it, as a matter of fact.
He wants the waffle fry.
And I got Kaya. Look, Kaya. From your press conference.
Oh!
And then I got one more, and I got a mat. So, because I thought it would be cool, you could draw on it the Pokemon that they play.
Yes.
And then you can have, like, as your little memento to your
the
press conference.
Characters on it, yeah.
And for Victoria, look. Jason David Frank.
Yes.
And Jason David Frank. and kind of you and Jason David Frank, but then one with the wall magnet to put on your fridge. There you go, you and Jason David Frank. Isn't that wonderful?
That's wonderful. Thank you.
We don't have frames yet for those. We ordered those frames. These are what we got from In Your Face Art that he gave us. And then those are for Kaya once we get frames for it. And that's for me once we get frames for it. So they're just duplicates of pictures that we already have. And now, Kaya made a Shutterfly book from our trip to MomoCon. Do you want us to whip that thing out now?
Yes, please. Yes.
What's that?
I was just coming over here to eat. I didn't realize I was in the
Rufus thinks it's for him.
Situation.
MomoCon 2022. This is your first Shutterfly book you've ever made, right? Are you excited?
Yes, I am. I'm very excited. Okay,
we got to get the wrapper off.
Scissors.
Yes. All right, Kaya.
Okay.
Kaya
so
made this.
Here's the spine.
MomoCon 2022. We just start at the front. Take us through it. I know Rufus. I know Buddy. Oh, wouldn't that be quite a thing if they were all empty?
Oh, my God. I'd be so
invisible ink. A convention to remember with me. You like this?
Yes, I'm very happy right now. We have day one.
And Kai made this all by herself.
The fanfiction panel.
No. Yeah. Signatures galore. It's like a yearbook. It's like a MomoCon yearbook. Rimaru?
Yes.
Uh-oh, DDR.
Friendly competition.
Oh, boy.
This is cool.
More signatures. Haku?
Patterson did not die during this one. It was an out-of-body experience.
It was. That's true. That's true. Different cosplay.
Three.
Oh, this is the Victoria feature.
Yes, yes, this is. It's a wonderful feature. It's a...
I lost.
Yeah, I did lose to the sword duel.
What's this? Take a nap.
The Demon Slayer meetup. Somebody yelled out Lemon Army, so I just kind of...
There it is.
Went with it.
And there's pages for you can get people to sign it. All right, turn it.
Flip.
Bowing down to Nezuko. Duel of Friends.
Is this the last? Yeah.
Oh, that actually turned out really good. So it's been impossible for us to get this picture, but that gets it. Where is you?
I am. Yeah, there.
Right there. And what's left?
And then this is the Shutterfly thing.
And then the back page. Another weekend comes over. Yeah, that's when you were going to read taking that. Are you pleased with this?
Yes, I am.
I think it looks wonderful. So she made that all by herself to celebrate her first normal con.
Wonderful.
And now we're going to hang out with the pup. Victoria, what are you doing over there? Huh?
I'm having lunch.
And then it's Ian Malcolm time. Seductive. Yes?
Okay, I guess.
Do it. Don't
we're getting ready to leave. What are you packing in your purse?
No,
the whole 6-pack of chocolate chip cookies? What else is in the purse?
Like that.
What else is in the purse?
Reese's Pieces.
Cookie Bites.
Cookie Dough Bites. Some assorted gummies. I believe I got some Whoppers down in there.
Oh, she's got Whoppers. You're just going to walk in just gangster style. I'm a hat of Whoppers.
You.
Like a Rufus. You me? Yes. Oh, can I have Whoppers? Nobody can't have Whoppers. Woo. AMC Theaters.
Yeah, that Greek food smells good.
Oh, it
though.
Does smell good. It does smell good. And we had chicken nuggets, too. Sugarloaf Mills. You gonna get that T-Rex? From the MacGuffin's bar? Alright, everybody say cheese. Everybody say cheese. Strike a pose. Strike it. That was a video. Is that guy trying to sell us AT&T and a half like a Target?
Oh,
I'll do a survey for him. Is it for AMC?
Yeah.
It's not for AT&T internet?
I don't actually know that.
I mean, I'll do. I want $5. I spent enough money at AMC. Let me ask the man. If it's a survey to like help the theater, I'll do it. Try to help him out. If I gotta buy AT&T internet, I won't do it. So that was not. If it's like the theater or like the GameStop, I always try to do the surveys to help the Studio Ghibli Fest 2022 with no face, because it helps the theaters. So I try to do that. That was not. That was all about Holiday Inn Express, but hey, I got a $5 AMC gift card. It literally took 30 seconds. And it was about hotel chains you're going to stay at if you travel for work or travel. I travel a lot, so hey. $5. But look, I got that poster's awesome. They've got some sort of prize. It's time to see Jurassic World.
He's saying to that Miyamoto's.
Kiki's Delivery Service and Spirited Away.
Uh-huh.
Oh, that's Anime Weekend Atlanta weekend, too, that Spirited Away is going on.
Oh, I heard Ponyo is really good.
Oh. That's cool. That's cool. Oh, you're just buttering it up? Oh, did you get the tin? Is it cool?
It's metal.
Oh, it's metal?
See?
Oh, yeah, that's cool. Oh, and it's hot. Hot pants.
It's fresh popcorn.
Look at that. That's wonderful.
It just popped out of the thing.
Ooh.
Come to this place.
Is this your favorite part?
For magic.
It is. Go ahead and say it.
To love, to cry.
Come on, say it.
To care.
Don't you know it by heart?
All of us. That indecisive.
Well,
I cried a lot.
Did you enjoy the movie? Kyle,
yeah,
did you like the movie?
I did really like it. It was really
Victoria,
good.
Victoria, did you like the movie?
I did.
Where are you at? There's you. I know Natalie loved it.
I loved it.
That's
good.
It's like it got bombed on Rotten Tomatoes, but it has an A cinema score.
Yeah.
They got a standing applause in our theater.
Yeah.
I don't know what people are looking for in the end, if this is truly the end of the Jurassic Park franchise. Like, is the plot good? No, absolutely not. I mean, it makes no sense. But none of the plots have been good since the book. Because how do you figure out a way to, like, oopsies, poopsies, there's dinosaurs again? Like, you just have to make up a dumb reason. But it gives you every bit of the Jurassic Park nostalgia, especially because we just watched them all recently. Yes. I mean, there are so many homages, some overt, some not as overt.
Yeah.
Let's slow down before we go outside. And it's emotional.
Very.
It makes me want to go see my puppy.
Yes. Yeah.
Quite a bit.
I want to snuggle my Ruben.
It's fun. I mean, Jeff Goldblum is wonderful.
Wonderful.
So funny.
Wonderful.
But all of them. I mean, having all the characters together.
It was really wonderful seeing them all on
and
screen.
It's a see it. And I mean, you get everything you want. Yeah. Like they learn some lessons of some things people don't like in other movies, and fixed it. I don't know what people don't like about this.
I thought it was great. Like, I highly recommend it.
I mean, honestly, it ain't terribly different than. Like Endgame and the things, it's like, all right, we're gonna bring all your people and we're gonna let them do some
that's
good
what
stuff.
It is. I mean, that's just what it is.
It's not, you know, that plot wasn't great either. If you're really honest with yourself, we enjoyed it. I mean, it's good night out, fun, emotional. I mean, I have such nostalgia for the original Jurassic Park theme because that's the first time I remember being in theater going, oh, what? Oh. And so they never truly played the whole thing, but many times they gave you all the different themes. It's a definitely go see it in theater. Is it as good as Top Gun? No. It's not as good a movie as Top Gun, but it's a great night.
It is great.
So
great.
I don't know why.
I may
have been
better than Top Gun for me. But
yeah, I mean, depending on
your
opinion. Yeah, I mean, it's, you know, it's really good. It's just really good. I don't know why people don't like it.
I'm so
loved.
Yeah, it's great.
And you know, y'all know my rules on this. Don't let other people judge for you.
Yeah.
Go see it. And you know what? There's plenty of stuff that does suck and is negative in the world.
Yeah.
Don't let your night to the movies be that. Even if you're like, it's marginal. Hey, it's better than going to work.
That's right.
Like, just enjoy it for what it is. And like, as fans, we got to stop being so, well, you know, it's not as good as the first one. Shut up. Yeah. Just go watch the movie and enjoy it. Like,
if you like it, you like it. If you don't, you
know. So what? And I don't know. I don't know why people don't like this because it's
I don't know.
Everything I expected it to be, honestly.
Yeah,
it's predictable. It's, you know, you kind of know the things that are going to happen, but it's the end of a franchise that's not going to kill all of its main characters. It's just not going to do that. It's not what it's going to be. So, you know, we loved it. And this video is like 2 hours and 15 minutes long.
Oh, goodness.
So we're going to wrap it up right here at the AMC with the automated tickets. So we had a wonderful time. Ranger Stop and Pop. Thank you to them for having us out.
Yeah.
It's basically the whole thing. And then we saw the movie. I think that's everything we've done in this video. I think so.
Yeah.
Well, if you watched our Friday hunt video from 2 days ago, you saw Natalie let loose with a huge squeeze that made me tore her run away and flee.
Do you have these again?
Do you want another huge one, or do you just want to give us the squeeze?